All right, y'all got it?
Bro. Stop.
Do you see how close
you got it, bro? You got it?
Move in a little closer because sometimes I got to like squish it.
Yeah, right here. We're good.
All right.
You comfortable though, right?
I swear this is the closest y'all have ever been on a recording.
That's a bit weird. No, because normally, like, if you're not here, then we have space. So, yeah, we don't have to be this close. You're right.
And I know you
But you're comfortable though, right?
Oh, my. Why you ask him?
Man, are you comfortable though?
I'm good.
Okay. Just a half a scoot to the right. Both of y'all.
Half?
Well, to the left. To the
right?
Don't you scoot to the right. Don't you dare scoot.
This is like when they try and squish three people in the bus seat.
Back in the day. That was the most annoying thing in the world. Like, yo, just go run another route. Like, what are we doing right now?
Oh, shit. That's how you knew your school was running out of money, when they told you to squish in a third on the bus seat. I was like, ah, shit, we're down bad. Mom, it's time to move.
And they dead ass will pull that shit out, too. Niggas be sitting on the floor in the middle of the bus just so they can get to school. And then get out the fucking thing, and half of the class is in one bus. It's crazy. And in another bus, there's like three niggas coming out. The most ridiculous thing, bro. I'm like, y'all niggas need to rework y'all routes.
Hey, man, welcome back to another episode of the Peer to Peer Podcast. My name, of course, is Agent Zero. Today, I'm joined with my co-host. I only have one of those, so you should know who you are.
Yo, what up, people? It's the one and only legend, Winnie, a.k.a. Low.
Oh.
You ain't had nothing else, bro? That's all you coming with today?
Second channel. Make sure you click the link in the description for the second channel. New videos coming real, real soon. You know what I'm saying? Top of the month. Got a couple already recorded in the tuck. You know, it's going to be a movement when that shit drops. That's going to be a big facts. Big facts. But we also have a special guest.
Very special guest.
Who's that? That's me?
That's you.
What do you do? No, let me stop.
Stop.
It's me, Omar.
Who are you? Tell them who you are.
Is that what we're getting into first?
We still have to do the rest of the intro, but I guess he just wants you to just introduce who you are.
I'm Lowe's twin brother.
That's not how that works.
The better looking one, because there's always a better looking one in the fraternal set.
Can't be that either.
But you know, I'm just a young one from Atlanta running the streets.
Okay. All right. Well, why don't you look at that? Hey, if y'all new to the podcast, make sure to subscribe. We do the videos on YouTube at Peer to Peer. Make sure to definitely go.
Is this Spotify? Is that what you're
trying to? No, you dropped the ball. Wait. He said, if you're on YouTube, hit the subscribe button and.
Oh, hit the bell to be noted. Act like, come on now.
I was about to say
Spotify, Stitcher, Google
we
Play people.
Had to cut this shit off. You had to kiss
We had to get
and
lead
fuck
on.
Joe Rogan. So,
oh man.
Oh, go ahead. Keep going.
Yeah, we don't feel that way, right, Lo?
No. We don't. You got to come for the head.
Oh, for sure. For sure. Yeah, man. Fuck NPR too, then. All right. Okay. Fuck all these top podcasts.
All right, then.
And Apple Podcasts people, make sure to drop a 5-star. If you're a Joe Rogan fan, drop a 5-star.
If you don't drop a 5-star, then you ain't black. So,
Keep going. And if you aren't black, figure it out.
Yeah.
Hey, Omar, it's good to have you on the podcast, man. Actually, you know what, Lo? Since you guys are so closely related, you know what I mean?
Closely.
You guys have been bumping heads since birth.
Closely related? You mean we're just related?
You're so closely related. Why don't you take this one, man?
Oh, wow.
So you literally start a pod and then say, you know what? It's your pod. That's the most ridiculous thing you ever done.
Stop rubbing on my knee. But go ahead.
Your hands are literally down there and you're telling me to stop rubbing on your knee.
We're not going to mention my shades, though?
I was literally about to. I thought you were going to say something in your intro, but I guess
it's a cold world, Lo.
What's the explanation to the fit?
I'm super underdressed.
In this 80-degree weather.
I'm putting together a video and I need to get some, what do you call them? Props? Some props for the video? And this is one of them. So y'all can see me. Just oh my God, it's fucking bright.
Yeah.
God damn it, Lo. Why is it this bright, man? This shit works. It's an effective sunglass.
Yeah, that's what it's called.
These are called sunglasses. These are 5%.
Imagine what they'll do when you're outside when the sun is up. Imagine the type of shade.
It might just be dark out.
Yeah, exactly. Imagine
I've actually never put on sunglasses before. Like, ever.
You have them on. Why do you have them then?
For a video. It was a prop. I'm going to be... God damn it. I can't get used to it. Hey.
What about the rest of the fit? Is that just some stuff you normally have? Or?
Yeah, it's just how I'm just usually just how I walk around the house.
Bro. Is your bedroom fit?
I be going to sleep in bombers.
That's the weirdest.
A lot of the time, man. No cap. And a Scully. You know what I mean? It's cold out today.
You're a weirdo, then.
It's not. But
it's cold. It's cold somewhere, though.
But not here.
Nah,
you don't believe in cold, right?
Yeah, you
cold
did say
does
that.
Not exist.
Okay, so what's so
the feeling of cold? The concept is real.
But what is the purpose
but
of that?
But the feeling you get, that's not a real feeling, bro. But we know
so
that.
What's the point of the jackets if you don't?
Because it helps keep you, like, let's say you say something to me, right? Okay. I help keep the information tucked. Because it's...
For the jacket?
Yeah.
I thought you would say that for the Scully, but...
For all of that.
Y'all call it a Scully or a beanie, is it?
Scully, for sure. Okay. Beanies don't have this right here, the ball at the top. You know? So if it's a beanie, you don't have the ball. Scully's got the ball, and he got the bucket hat. I'm messing with the bucket hat, by the way.
I'm super underdressed. I should have worn a hat or a jacket.
Yeah, it's cold out. I don't know how you came here like
Mind
that.
Mind you,
it's
I walked in, y'all had cold. On shorts and t-shirts. You went downstairs for 5 minutes. You went to the bathroom for 10. And these are all the clothes I ever got.
You should have came prepared, man.
I hate y'all.
Kobe.
Yeah.
Kobe.
Damn, we lost the game. We were down 3
anyway. Damn, you were 0-2. You were back-to-back 0-2.
Hey, fuck it,
and
man.
And you did it so unconsciously, too. You just like, nah, just keep chucking.
You got to come with that attitude, man.
Yeah, it's crazy because you definitely could have got a jersey. Because I have, like, you know, a few jerseys downstairs.
Shut
it's
up.
Tough.
Now, Shut how up. Would they fit him?
I think it's just about the visual. But it's okay. It's okay.
No, it's about the fitment.
It's okay. I know for next time. Mm. That's A-okay.
Okay, cool. So, Omar, tell us about yourself,
explain
man.
Explain who you are.
Oh, no,
explain
I'm
on your journey.
How'd oh, you my journey. I touched down in 96, knew I was the man by the age of 6. I think Drake is super overrated. But I'm Lowe's brother, you know, the inspiration and reason for a lot of the videos that you see him post. A lot of the logic, he might add one or two things, but you know, definitely get fact checked by me. 23. College student, soon to be content creator. You know, yeah, you don't know about that.
He has a third channel coming.
We're working.
He's a third.
A third channel.
You don't even know about the first two.
Yeah, we're working. Don't I'm LinkedIn. So don't
you
worry
can't
about
be
that.
A. You can't be a.
Soon, I said soon to be content.
But then how you have three channels if you assume?
I didn't say anything was on the channels.
Oh man, no, if that's the case, I'm gonna create 5 channels and just say I got my 6th channel.
Get your subs up.
Smart man.
Anyway, smartest one in the family, handsomest one in the family, funniest one in the family. If it was a accolades contest, I'd guess I have them all. Even the got that first in the family. Yeah, so
you got what?
I had past tense. First to get rid of the family.
Wait, I can't talk to you serious. Okay, he's not being serious.
Does it matter? I had it past tense.
Yeah, it does matter, bro.
I don't think that's real, so. Yeah,
of course.
What else do you want to know?
You're a true Georgian, man.
Yeah, true Georgian with a little New York spice in me. Pause. Shouts out to Phantom.
Okay.
That's weird.
With that out of the way, yeah, because you're not from New York. I'm kind of confused.
No, but you can have a little spice in you from other places, you know, if you got that mentality. You're a true Georgian.
Have you ever been to New York?
Yeah, several times.
That's cap.
I used to vacation in New York.
That's cap.
Yeah, yes. I've been to New York as well.
Exactly. Bro, you said you haven't been there.
No, I have not.
Bro, what's the place you said you haven't been?
Toronto, probably.
I've been to Cali. I've been to New York. I've been
that's
to Florida.
Cap. Mm. You don't leave your house.
No, come on now.
Literally. Bro, he's lying.
We're well traveled. We have pictures too.
Yeah, pictures of everything. Pictures of everything.
Where's the library at?
I don't read books.
Oh my god. Okay, so I want to learn about you guys growing up. You got okay. Let's do some scenarios. You're at home. Your dad brings you home a GameCube. You guys are playing Super Smash Bros. Melee.
He's dead. He was dead at that point. So
okay, your mom.
All right. Who was winning the Smash Brothers?
Mm-hmm.
Can I lock?
Smash Brothers. I don't know about Smash. We play Smash Brothers on 64, not on GameCube.
Ooh. Just go.
But
with
Mario
God
Kart.
God damn it! It's hypothetical.
But Mario Kart. I was beating him in Mario Kart.
All right. So let me.
And that's a fact.
I'm the younger brother, so there were definitely a good majority of the games that I wasn't winning in at the time.
Even now, you're not. What?
Who won the last time we played 2K? The last two times we played
2K. Lowe's ass. No cap. I'm not even exaggerating for the content. No, he's actually genuinely ass.
But let's be clear. Do I own a PS4 right now?
I don't know.
No.
Yeah.
And who won the last two times we played 2K?
The two times I let you get it?
No. Because how did I beat you both times?
I let you win.
No, how did I beat you both times? A Trae Young buzzer beater and a Luka Doncic buzzer beater.
Which is the craziest thing in the world.
You suck at the game.
That's tough. Because you know he plays team up day and night.
I don't.
He sucks at the game.
You know what's crazy? The last time I actually played 2K was like 2 or 3 weeks ago.
That's such cap.
I don't even know.
When last time we recorded? Well, outside of the PC thing, when last time we recorded?
Like 2 weeks ago.
Okay,
that's not the last time you played.
He's legend of losing. He lost twice.
He loses weight. You know what's crazy? In 16, when we used to play my team all the time together, I had him on the series like 26-4 or something.
No, you did not. Oh my! First of all, First of all, your team was better than mine. Literally, one of my best players was a Byron Scott,
and that was a cheesy Byron Scott.
And he would still get outplayed, and he had Steph Curry. Easily.
What was the record?
I don't know. We didn't even play that many times.
Yes, we played at least 30 times.
We played 30 times on my team?
Yes.
I have a really good team right now, and I don't think I played 30 games on my team.
We have, bro.
No, we did not.
Listen.
Anyway, besides the point.
You're not good at 2K.
Yeah, you just.
But no, he would beat me at the other games, but he's just not good at 2K.
Nigga, we can get off this podcast right now. I know. So both of y'all.
I beat you last 2K. Time.
Who? I would smoke both. I mean, dead ass. I would smoke you in 2K.
All right, legend of losing.
I can tell you.
Nigga. I would smoke you.
Okay.
It wouldn't even be competitive. We might have to actually consider quitting after the second quarter.
Okay, you guys get home. You know, one of you guys is pissed. Starts a fight with the other one. Who wins?
It depends on the age, but me.
You wouldn't.
It depends on the age, but me.
And I would actually be very excited to see you guys fight.
I don't. And now if they've never seen like my body.
Plus we've never
watched the AMP wrestling video. Pause. Yeah, we don't. Really, I mean,
no,
but
body?
I'm saying they. You know, you can see our. But watch the AMP wrestling video, and you can see like our full bodies. He's bigger than me, so when I was young, I might have got.
But we never wrestled. Really, we never really fought though.
Yeah,
for real? Not really.
Oh man, I exclusively fought with my brother.
Do I come across as somebody who would just fight people though?
No, but not like fist fight.
I would say either of us.
More like wrestling with your brother.
Not really.
You wrestle with each other?
No.
Not really.
You guys just shook hands and shit.
But there were times that we did, and there was definitely times I just had to let him know.
Mm.
And you lost, right?
Is there videos?
It depends on the age.
Is there videos?
Is there videos?
Yeah. No, the world video started.
I don't know, man.
It depends on the age, but there was some times where
people who don't know, we're 3 years apart.
I said that.
Okay, but just as a reminder, it's not like the gap is that big of a.
That's the reason why I whooped your ass.
No, what I'm saying is don't excuse when you got your ass whooped. Oh, okay, all right, nigga. That's what I thought.
I was young.
Yo, Lo, when you were in school and he was like a few grades behind you, were you embarrassed to him a little bit?
No. We only literally had 1 year in high school together.
Because I was the coolest. And even in elementary school. Next.
You only had 1 year. 1 year in high school.
Can you tell me about Lo in school? Like, what was he like, man?
It was literally 1 year high school. That's it.
One year high school, he made me late to school every day. But other than that, I mean, we just stayed our several. I mean, I was one of the.
Wait, what kind of student was he, though? When he walked in there, was he trying to impress people? Was he mad low key?
Why do you think? No. Low key.
Three times.
Did he get bullied? Like, have you gone into the washroom and you saw him get his head like slammed to a toilet or something?
No, I don't know what freaky school you went to.
That's what I'm saying. What are you talking
about?
Y'all
were like pulling pants down and looking at it. Like, that's TV stuff. And I wish they would stop doing that on TV.
Word, because I've never seen that happen before. You gave me no intel there on what kind of student Lo was, by the way. You just said he was low key.
He was just a low. I mean, listen.
Was he lonely? You think he was lonely?
Nah, he had three friends. But that's all you really need at the end of the day. Just like now, how y'all only have like two friends, three friends. Am I wrong?
Really? Yeah, I guess so. Yeah.
You had two friends. You had more than two friends.
No, I'm saying yeah.
Yeah.
No, I'm talking about right now. Yeah, I guess you're right. Only two or three friends.
You only need two or three friends for real. For real.
Niggas is really not. You know,
they're weird.
Yeah, weird.
Yeah, people are weird. That's a mistake I made in high school. Even in elementary school, like I just knew everybody, bro. Like everybody. Like, you'd be walking down the fucking hallway, like hey, you just everyone.
But
everyone
that's not
is
your friend. Because I mean, I knew.
Nah, but it wasn't though. Like, okay, and I didn't really know anybody closely ever. in high school. Like, I never really got to know nobody. It was just like, you know, they would talk about shoes and I would pretend to care. I didn't even pretend to care because I didn't give a fuck about shoes. But like, we had common interests. We kind of just kept it pushing, but we never really were like that close. But that shit was horrible. Yeah, when I went to uni, I didn't try and do the same thing. You can't know everybody in uni though. I just started to get to know people better. So yeah, that's a good point.
You know, it's crazy. I'm the exact opposite. All my friends from high school are still my friends to this day. And when I got to college, I tried to make little to no friends because that's when they really started getting weird.
Why? Wait, you went to college?
No, I'm currently in college.
He's just in college. Wow, college-educated black man.
Not yet, but CS major because, you know,
computer science?
Yeah.
Oh, you're depressed. Let's talk about your depression right after this. Okay, yeah, you trying to make no friends.
They were weird.
Computer science students are weird, though.
Them too. I mean, just all the kids in college. And then
no,
I did.
Not.
Everyone's weird.
I was like, everyone's weird. You're just walking up. And let me say,
maybe it was the campus and
everybody's weird.
But a lot of them just didn't have the same interest. I done seen two dudes at the rec center get into a fight, and one of them starts like quoting Bible scripture. So, like, that's not anything that I can relate to. Not that I'm a heathen, but I just don't.
What an attempt to break up a fight.
No, I'm just saying. No, not break. This is one of the. What's nigga, up, bro? You know what Deuteronomy said? And it's like, what are you talking about?
Nigga just get on these praying right before
you fight. Hold on,
what
dog.
A unique way to defuse the situation.
Hold on, dog. Do you want to lead in the Lord's Prayer? Right. Like, that's weird.
Mm.
So I can relate to that. Mm. Oh, me. Let's continue the game.
Mm.
Please, let's finish this game. I didn't relate. I don't know. Maybe it's me, but all my friends from high school are still my friends. Love them.
Yeah.
You said depression?
Let's talk about your depression. Yeah. I took a couple CS classes
before
in my
time. This, but the fact that you literally brought him over here because you thought you were going to get some type of intel on how I grew up. Oh,
get intel.
No, you're not.
Hey, Omar.
Because the craziest thing, I don't really tell him stuff either.
But so I don't even know why you thought.
All right, buddy.
Extraordinary lives either.
I don't know what the fuck you thought we were doing.
I'm gonna get some intel.
I might have been doing even like the more wilder stuff out of both. I can say shit. The more wilder shit out of the two of us.
Wait, what?
Yeah, I was probably doing the more wilder shit out of the two of us.
Like what? Like you were fighting? Or
I thought you wanted to get to my depression. No.
You were jerking off publicly? Like what's going on? No,
jerking off what? Publicly.
Have you ever caught low?
Watching porn or masturbating? Yes, but that's brother shit.
So I'm pretty sure. How is that brother shit? Don't normalize that. What the fuck?
You never seen?
No, bro. What the hell? I would be traumatized. Genuinely traumatized. What was that? Can you walk me through that story real quick?
I beat my meat, so I'm not going to be traumatized on it.
Seeing another person do it is traumatizing.
Oh, I mean, it wasn't like
especially when you know them live in the house with them.
It wasn't like I walked through the door and he's facing the door trying to jack off. That's weird.
Did he keep going after you entered?
I wouldn't stop, so I'm pretty sure he did. You finish?
I don't remember this. So I don't
know. And it might have even been like I'm not sitting there like, damn, well, what category is that? Like, I'm not asking all those questions.
So how did it go down? Like, walk me through. Give me a play by play on this situation.
I probably needed something in my black ass. I never knocked. So I just came in, seen the porn on the screen, maybe seen
what
him
were you playing
under, like,
on
a cover
TV
or something like that. Yeah.
Yeah, because my house, my TV was like your TV is on the wall.
You just played on. You know how bold you have to
I'm
be
not gonna lie,
to be in your parents' house playing it on the TV.
That's pretty freaky to have TV on.
With no lock on the door, bro. You was taking risks in life.
I would assume somebody would just knock on the door before they came in.
Yeah, I'm not gonna lie. I wasn't knocking on the door, but now the freaky part was having the porn on the screen. I'm not gonna lie. You can't.
What was he watching?
It's probably some lesbians or something like that.
Okay,
that's
the go-to
category. Ebony lesbians.
Mm.
Facts.
You don't want to see no dicks.
Word.
You don't want to see no dicks anymore.
That's facts. That's facts.
Wow.
The category. What category did you go to? Don't lie.
I don't actually watch porn.
Oh my god.
He's gonna lie. Exactly.
Why?
No, I've watched it.
No, but I'm saying. All right. So what were your go-tos back then?
I don't know, bro. My go-to changed like every 3 months. I get bored of some shit, and then
thought you said you don't watch porn though.
I used to.
Nigga
said every 2 or 3 months.
Nigga, that sounds like somebody who does it expeditiously.
You got a subscription.
Expeditiously.
So what were your go-to guys?
Nigga said it switch ups every 2 or 3 months.
And tell me the sites.
Huh?
Because I've run out.
No, I never actually had sites. The only site, aside from like Pornhub, is there's a site called Beeg, BEEG. But the only reason I fuck with that site is because it's such high quality. You don't even have to ever bump into bad quality videos. Yeah, you know when you click on a video and the thumbnail is clear and then the video is all pixelated?
I'm a high quality porn guy now. So still, what were your categories? Stop.
I don't know. don't know, bro. Like, if you, like, there were stages where I was like, oh, redhead, man, this is a nice category right here. And then 3 months later, it was like, ebony, bro. Wow, look at that.
If your preferred category is changing every 2 to 3 months, that means you're watching it. Yeah, you're watching it a lot.
You love it.
Maybe like once every couple weeks.
A couple times a week. That's a lie.
And then I stopped doing it.
When you were going through puberty, you didn't watch porn a lot.
I'm assuming that's the time you're talking about, right?
Yeah, but I didn't have time to, bro. You're acting like I had time to. I was in a house and there was people in the house. And I wasn't playing it on the TV. I wasn't as bold as Lowell. I'm not gonna play it on the TV, man. That's you taking risks in life.
Jack off in the bathroom or something like that. I found a way to get it in. I haven't found a way to get it in with people like in the room, so
I know you've never done that. I don't know about that. Have you ever tried it in public though? Just by yourself, just jerking off in public.
In my car, yeah.
For real? Mm-hmm. Wow.
Does car count as public? Because every single time I say I've had sex in public and I say in the car, people say no, that's not in public.
I don't know. It kind of is and it isn't.
Yeah.
One time I was so horny in grade 10, bro. No, it was grade 11.
Why you know the grade? That's how I know.
Because I remember the exact class and date. I was like, man, there was this girl I was looking at and she wasn't even fine at all, bro. At all. But in my mind, I was like, man, like I don't know what was up with me that morning, bro. Just bugging, bro.
Yo.
And you know when you're at that age, you just get random boners all the time. But then this one didn't even go away. It just like stayed the whole class. And I was dead ass contemplating, just asking to go to the bathroom and then just trying to get rid of it. Because I was fucking the whole class. I couldn't think about shit but that. And I was like, man, it was at that moment I realized this shit has gone too far.
Let me tell you a story.
It's gone too far.
Let me tell you a story. This is in ninth grade. This is like people think I'd be like boosting my story. This is dead ass. This is no boost, dead ass serious. I was in class as a social studies, and on the left of me was like a friend of mine, like two or three friends. Actually, it was Jeffrey. Jeffrey was on the left of me, and on the right it was some dude. And we moved when I was in ninth grade to a new school district, so I really wasn't too familiar with the people, but some people I knew. So she's doing her thing, you know, on the whiteboard, putting shit up there, reading out the textbook and shit like that. And then she tells us to like read us out a section, like read off of a section and shit like that. And then we're supposed to like fill out a worksheet. So we're doing that and people are like, we're quiet because everybody's reading. All I hear off to the side is like this type of noise.
Oh, we got legend of winning ASMR in this motherfucker, man.
And I looked over to my side.
Oh, I know the story.
I looked over to my side and this nigga is literally jacking off in the middle of class. And he's the fucking preferred content that he's looking at is a fucking Game Informer. And Tomb Raider was on it.
Oh, Lara Croft is dying though.
That's weird.
As this nigga's jacking off, I tell my man Jerry, like, look at this nigga, this weirdo right here. Like, what's going on? And then this teacher literally had to, like, get him and, like, take him to the thing, like, take him out. And then eventually somebody was, like, everybody was like, yo, this nigga's wilding. Because then they said, yeah, this nigga's done that before. I was like, nigga, what?
Serial master baiter.
So as they're walking out, she comes back in and says, like, I don't want her to tell you no more. Like, she opened the door and, like, kind of getting done with the conversation, just said, yeah, I don't want to tell you no more. Just go back to your seat.
Now, mind you, he didn't wash his hands in this story. He really didn't have no lube. So if you ever masturbated without no lube, then you know how that is in class. That's a freak.
That was the weirdest shit I've ever witnessed in my life.
Stuff like that didn't happen to you? No.
And the nigga's literally like 3 feet away from me. Like I can like damn near see this nigga dick peeling out his pants right now. Like that's how close this nigga is.
Man, that was a bad time. What are you peeling?
Apparently his dick out his pants. Go ahead.
High school was such a bad time, bro. Like I just be walking.
We weren't in high school. We was in middle school.
Oh, that's even crazier.
Yeah.
What the fuck?
I said ninth grade. I'm sorry, eighth grade.
Oh, that's wild.
Never mind.
Nigga is a weirdo. Yeah.
But you just get boners for no reason. I remember I'd just be walking to school, and then right when I get there, it's boner. And then you're trying to get rid of it, but when you try and get rid of it, it stays. Then you have to forget about it, but you can't because it's just bulging out there. And then you got jeans on or something, so it's like, man, it was just like.
How you used to adjust it?
I used to just put it on the side of my thigh or something.
Yeah, because you got jeans on, so
I'll try to. And then hope that they don't notice. But if you like pack enough things in your pockets,
I was dead as gonna say the same thing too. If I just start like randomly putting a calculator in my pocket, just to like give it a little, just to get a little leeway.
Somebody told me that if you have like some math problems in front of you, or like if you can look up some math and you try to solve that problem, it'll get rid of your erection, and it actually works.
Well, that wouldn't work with me. So
damn, you be getting horny at math.
I would be able to answer the question with like way too quickly for me to be like, I would have but to have I'm like saying, a slew of math questions.
Okay, get the slew, but I don't think you should be getting horny.
You gotta
at math,
put together
though.
A gauntlet
for your erection.
I would not have to be like how getting get erection to go away, then? And then try to figure out like what is 3x plus 4 equal like equal 12 or something. Like I would be like, no, I know the answer already, so like that's not gonna work.
Mm. Whew. Fuck math, man. Fuck everyone associated with math.
Apparently he's fucking math, so that's why he's getting horny to math.
Technically you could fuck a zero and some
stop
eights
it. Stop it.
Okay,
stop.
And a nine. Stop. Six
it. Stop. Yo, I don't know if
you
I can say
go
this.
Crazy on a couple threes.
I don't know if I can say this, but Wispy Cream on stream was saying, what if you met a nigga or met a girl with like two penises or two vaginas?
That'd be wild.
Like, would you be able to hang? Like, would you?
Wait, what am I gonna do with the two penises?
I don't shoot, but she was.
She was posing to everybody.
Yeah, she was posing to everybody.
Okay. I say me. I can't hang with none of that.
Because low key, Wispy lied. She lied on stream, and she's like, because it first came up with like, if niggas have like small dicks, like how do you deal with that? And she lied with some bullshit saying, well, if I'm already in love with him, then I'll be fine, or like some dumb shit.
Let's get this out of the way. I don't mean to interrupt you. Women only need 3 inches. And I've looked this up. Look it up right now. You can look it up right now. The G spot.
I'm not gonna look it up because you know what Google Image is gonna show me, bitch.
No, it's gonna show you the female anatomy. But a G spot is only 3 inches in. You only need 3 inches to satisfy women.
Yeah, but your dick would have to be curved for the tip of your 3-inch penis to fuck.
I mean, you could get some movement going. That's where the motion in the ocean comes.
You're going to be. But that means she has to have a fucking flat ass.
Let's say
a pancake ass. So
you got a position.
No, listen. A girl with ass.
Listen.
You can get in there with 3 inches
you
and
have,
be like,
you can find a way to make the 3 inches work, but you only need 3 inches. Even if you have, so no. what I'm trying to say is, even no, if you man. Only have 5, you're good enough.
All I know is this.
But keep what
you're saying is, if the girl has a fat ass, you're literally trying to part the seat just
you,
so you can.
No, listen.
In
and if you
quick.
If you got like 3 inches, you can't hit it from the back. You can only do missionary, and you better get skinny, get tight up in there, close your legs, and really press. You gotta get it. I'm finna look it up.
Because
now y'all
looking
at me like I'm crazy.
God damn.
So Wizard Cream was lying and said that you gotta fall in love with her. Then I was like, so like, how the fuck you falling in love with a nigga before you even fuck? That makes no sense at all. Then she's like, no, you just gotta, you know, convince her. I was like, so what, we just tricking? I was like, niggas with small dicks have to trick females to love. Just so they can, as soon as they get in the bed. Yo, imagine if you're a nigga with a small dick and right before you get in the bed where you be like, but you love me, right? Just to make sure. And then she looked disappointed and she's like, no. You said you love me now. So you're going to have to just take this 3-inch dick.
What did you pull up?
The G-spot is on the roof of the vagina at about 12 o'clock when the woman is lying on her back. Missionary. 2.5 to 3 inches in the vagina. Does it not say that right there?
I get that. But what I'm saying is, you have to have more than 3 because
5.
There's some. Okay, so that's an average.
Is it really?
Yeah, 5 is average. Yeah.
Oh, wow.
4.5 to 5.
Because a lot of people's capping.
I don't want to just. Women lie about that all the time. Oh, yeah, I got.
Men
be lying too. I got the 8-inch. No, you don't.
Yeah, women be lying about.
You have to brag about your dick size to your friends.
Yeah, don't brag to me.
Wait, not your friend.
No, but they be yeah, some people be bragging
people
about
brag to their
not brag, but they be lying. Like I give a fuck about how big your dick is.
You can't brag about it to a woman though, because you're gonna see it.
She's gonna see it.
No, no, no. Yeah. What's the point of fucking have sex in the dark the first time? Don't let her see it. That's a trick off.
There you go. I also told her on chat, make sure y'all lie first. So lie about go the other way. So if you got a 4-incher, say you really got a 3-incher, and so then you surprise her with the extra inch.
That's facts.
Though. Or she can't tell you there's the extra inch, and she's just fucking depressed by the fact that
it really is.
That means she has more than 3 bodies, and she's experienced. So
okay,
yeah. just a scenario, hypothetically.
Oh, yeah, Quizzy was lying. I was like, yo, that's not how that works. There's no way that she's gonna sit there and fall in love with a nigga who has a schmeet. That doesn't make any sense, bro.
I don't know, but I can't vouch for that. I don't know. Women fall in love with me, so.
Do they?
You have a schmeet?
Let's talk.
I don't know what schmeet is.
A small meat, nigga?
No, but I'm saying I don't know the inches. I haven't measured my dick probably ever, but I don't.
Well, word. I think it's odd that there's people.
What are you pointing at?
There's a ruler right here.
All right, pull it out.
Go in the bathroom. This nigga said pull it out.
We're going to pause the podcast for me to go in the bathroom.
Oh, no, we're not pausing.
You're gay.
That's.
I'm gonna think about some math to get. I've actually never measured my dick, so
you ain't never measured it. I ain't never measured my dick for real though either.
I've done it as well. So
you measured your dick?
Yeah, of course.
From shaft or where you start? Like from the base? Like the on shaft? Your body on your
one end to the other end.
You
gotta measure
things. No, what I'm saying, on your do you start from your body or do you include the tip? Some people don't include the tip.
Why would I not
include the
tip? I'm only measuring.
Listen,
shaft.
these are in the chats that
I'm shaft and without the tip.
These are in the forums that I'm in. Some don't include the tip.
A tip has to be included because that's the first thing that's going in.
No,
that's the first thing you feel.
What forums are you included on, my guy? Which forums is these?
I'm trying to make sure. How big a dick? No tip. No tip.
Like with or without tip. Like
with or without tip. He's like, yo, 5 inches? With or without the tip?
Without? Oh, wow.
That is true, because you could be all tip.
I'd be so pissed off if you ask me that shit.
You could be all tip. You could be all tip.
you would have to kill it. If you all tip, you have no other choice. Yo, nigga, if you're all tip, you have to measure that shit. There's absolutely no way.
This much shaft, that much tip.
You gotta count the tip. There's no way I'm going to go sit there and say shit is
tip.
That's a
shaft,
deformity, man. Tip. That's not natural, bro.
Like a fucking a Mario mushroom.
Why are y'all doing this?
There's literally no way I'm not counting the tip if that's how my dick is deformed, yo.
On a crazy side note, you guys ever play No Man's Sky? There's planets you can go to where they have like these mushroom trees that look like large penises. I swear to God, it's the most uncomfortable thing. I fly right back out the planet. I don't give a fuck what kind of resources you have.
Oh my God.
And sometimes they're toxic, so they'll kill you.
Toxic
mushroom penises? No Man's Sky, man.
Oh man. So is this what you came in to try to get some intel on me?
Okay, so let's try and get some intel on Low real quick, man.
Because it's nothing really.
You know, Low's a real private guy. You know, he keeps to himself.
I don't tell him much of anything.
Nah, I got it. I got the tea. But what are you about to ask me? Go ahead.
No, I want to hear the tea.
No, I'm not gonna lie, he is pretty private. I don't know if you expected to get some of the drip, like some story. He's a private guy.
Yeah.
But like I said earlier, we really live boring lives. We don't club. Clubs are so, I'm not paying $10 to park, to wait in an hour line, to pay $20 to get in, to hear music that I don't like, to not leave.
Or music I could have heard on Spotify at home.
Like that I could have instantly heard. I got to wait all night to hear the sped up version of a song that I really like.
And just one verse.
I hate people. before they move on to the next song. Have you been to a club before?
No, I just know how it works.
Oh yeah, you know.
Well, I've been to a club, but it's the worst thing.
I've been to a club.
I've been to clubs, just not while it was active. Like it was a site where we did.
But
it wasn't a club though.
No, I promise you, not missing nothing. And all those little TV shows.
I don't think I am. Yeah, I'm definitely not missing shit.
Some of the worst.
People who go to clubs like that are like low key depressed. Like they just be trying to go there.
Do you think it's because they get a high from going there and that like it's so exciting?
Yeah.
But then like. Then they wake up in the morning and nothing is that exciting. I feel like I'd just be a tad miserable. But you could track with that logic and make it seem as if doing anything of excitement is not worth doing because then you're going to go back to baseline and be bored. But that's not true.
I don't even get the excitement because you're not even dancing no more. Like, I was talking to somebody and I was like, you know, the most exciting thing was probably like in the 80s. And this is the first time you heard a song and you don't know the next time you'll ever hear that song. So like, no, I'm serious. Like back in the day, if March Madness came out, the first time you heard that song drop was right there in the club. And you're like, oh my God, that was the hardest thing I ever heard. Now people just standing on walls. This is literally what you do in a club.
If you want, people don't dance at clubs.
No.
I don't even know how to dance. That's why I don't go to a club. I'm not going to go there and just fucking post up.
No, that's what people do.
I could post up anywhere for
that's
free.
That's what people do, though.
There's plenty of places to post up for free.
Literally, shit, you can go downstairs and just lean on a wall. There's people, people come here with Waleed, they do more shit than they would do at a club. To be honest with you. Dead ass.
Or.
So, yeah, this is pointless.
Yeah, I feel like that's a. I don't know. I don't want to say something too crazy because I never experienced that, so I can't even talk on that. Yeah, I mean,
do it one time and go to a strip club one time.
I'll go to a strip club.
That's the next AMP video.
But I don't want to. I don't actually want to go to a club. I go to a strip club. They can't. We mean to go on.
No, they can't.
Too young.
We don't have to go with Davis.
Oh, he said AMP video.
Oh, Davis is not AMP.
I like
bro.
How he tried.
Yeah, damn. Davis is too young.
Davis is not.
How old is Phantom? Phantom don't know.
Yeah, I think he's 21 or 22.
How old is Davis? 19.
Yep.
Yeah.
Damn, Davis tripping. Yeah, we'll do an AMP video.
Jungle, bro. Davis, obviously AMP.
I'll replace Davis as the fourth.
But I'm going to be honest with you, because Davis is back by the time he's 20.
You can't even record at strip clubs, though. What strip clubs going to let you record?
Listen, we'll get enough footage.
Can you imagine you brought a DSLR into a strip club? Can you imagine? Well,
you can. I mean, technically, you can rent out a strip club and record in there, yeah.
Oh, no, we got to
go. They'll let you?
But you had to, like, rent it out. That's what people do with, like, music videos.
Oh, we got to go to, like, one of those, like, dirty strip clubs. I'm calling it a dirty strip
club. Nah, that like seems club, like a bad experience, bro.
Like Club Blaze or something like that.
Nah, like, where they're way too aggressive.
Not Club Blaze.
Dirty. That's why not?
Horrible. That's horrible. Why? I thought you meant, like, a hole in the wall.
Club, that's what I mean.
No, Club Blaze is not a hole in the wall. It's something that a lot of people know about. It's just a dirty strip club.
No. How about we just go to one that's not dirty?
No.
Just, you know.
You want to get the full experience for the $200.
Wait, what?
All you need is 200.
Why is it 200?
That's all you need. 200, and that's for parking, the sausage sandwich that's at the door entry fee, and the 200 will get you some fingers in there. So,
I don't know. I bet you the price is going up on pussy. I said this to somebody. The price on pussy is definitely going up.
Hold on. No, it's not. No, it's not. OnlyFans has dropped the price on pussy.
No, it has not.
You never seen a girl have a $399 OnlyFans? Like $399.
Yeah, but those are already broke females. And on top of that, it's the lockdown, because you can't say the C word on here. Just let you know.
So, Since you said it twice.
I said the C word?
Mm-hmm.
No, like the reason why we on lockdown.
Oh, okay.
The C word, yeah. You can't say that.
Oh, wow.
So I gotta go back and, you know, block that out. So when
I guarantee you're not gonna do it.
I've done it, yeah.
No, you're not gonna do it.
Oh yeah, I will.
I doubt it.
Okay. Anyway, so what about to say? Oh yeah, because the reason why, like, the whole reason we're on lockdown, there's a lot of strip clubs have been closed as well. So if the strip clubs are closed, that means more women just out there selling pussy. So if they're selling pussy and they know they can whatever they can get now, they can probably just get on OnlyFans.
Talking about selling pussy, but. That's where we're at. You remember when we first got on lockdown, they had those Instagram strip clubs?
For real?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Like Big Fendi in them? Mm-hmm. Those are better than regular strip clubs. So the way I see it, when regular strip clubs open back up, they're not?
No.
They have
what
some
is
freaky
an Instagram
stuff.
Strip club?
So they would go on live, and you know you could go on live with two people, and it would be like usually like a celebrity or whatever, and he would have a stripper come on. She would do a lot of stuff. A lot of stuff. Now, some of them went straight to the porn. It was basically just strip a little bit, bring out the dildo.
Oh, wow.
Can you say dildo?
Yo, do they do that at strip clubs?
No.
No.
All right,
Blaze.
Okay.
Which hole in the wall are you talking about?
We're talking about holes in the walls that don't actually have names. We're talking about like you just know somebody and you go. That's what I'm talking about.
He's plugged in.
Yeah, that sounds like something I'm not comfortable doing, man.
For the 200, though.
It doesn't even have a name, bro?
I mean, they have names, but it ain't like they can just go look it up. Or, like, if I said the name, y'all would know about it unless you knew the person who ran it.
So you know somebody like that?
Yeah.
He's capping, yo. Yeah. He's fucking capping, yo. Yeah. You about to pull up his number? All right, say his number on stream.
His number? What?
The strip club master. Yeah.
Yeah, Lo tells a lot of strip club stories.
He's a strip club master, apparently. I didn't know that.
Yeah, yeah,
if he knows it. I don't know how freaky you got to be to know like a secret. Is it today? Oh, no, it's not today.
You're so cringy the way you text, bro. So cringy.
How am I cringy?
My question is, how much is it to get the
Kobe?
Oh my God, we're losing. We're losing.
0 for 3.
How much is it to get the same thing that you would get at the name brand strip club? Because I'm trying to finger something,
bro. For 200, you could just invite someone to the house, bro.
Are you guaranteed to have sexual activities with this person?
No. Are you fucking at a strip club?
Yeah, you can.
For real?
Yeah.
Oh no. Nah.
We've already had this conversation,
and that's why we need to do an AMP. Who can bring home or have sex with a stripper at the strip club?
Well, no, there's a whole bunch of niggas with money, so they just whoever throw up the most money is gonna win.
I'll gladly lose that competition because to me that'd be a win.
What the fuck? You don't.
I'm not throwing the most money. I'm not gonna be the brokest at the end of the night. Are you crazy?
I can see Phantom literally trying to like go for it and like, yeah, I won. And then niggas like, yeah, you lost, nigga. So like,
you got the cheeks. It's a competition.
Stop. You can if you throw the right amount of money and go to the right strip club.
That's wild.
If you talk them right, you don't even got to really throw that much money. Just, you know, let them know like I like your personality type stuff.
Imagine telling a stripper you liked her personality.
They do it. People do it.
Hey, man. Imagine she just puts her clothes on to test you.
That's tough. That would be the craziest shit in the world. Bro. But they low-key, they'll do shit like when you pay them to do a whole bunch of extra shit in the back, and then they'll like, when y'all go to the back, they'll tap the bouncer, and the bouncer will give y'all like 5-10 minutes in the back with one another, and you think you're about to get it in, and they'll come in and be like, oh, you're doing too much, bro. You got to get out, and you just lost all your money.
That'd be a tough situation.
Oh, my gosh. Where have you been?
The strip club.
At what point in the podcast do y'all talk about the terrible content creators?
Oh, we could do that right now.
I've purposely slowed down on it just so, because I didn't want, you know, this to be that type of podcast, but
I feel like sometimes you do have to, and I didn't realize how much hate you got from when you, can I say the A word on here?
Asshole?
No, annoying TV.
Oh.
I didn't know. A word. I didn't realize how much hate you got from.
I didn't get much hate.
No, you still do, because I even watch videos now, like people's reaction videos too. Yeah, I just don't like that low character. For what he did to annoying every time.
You got reaction videos to our podcast?
To the podcast, to the AMP videos.
Nigga, what is this?
To his second channel.
I've never seen these.
You ain't never seen these?
Who's reacting to my second channel videos?
I don't want to say no names because I'm a gatekeeper and I don't want to give nobody any clout.
It's a fact. So, happy you know this fact.
No, it's definitely people that react to the videos. And every time
there's a nigga reacting to the podcast. If you react to the podcast, you a sick nigga.
So look.
3 hour reactions
are an hour and a half long already.
And I'm gonna make it worse. So this is what they say in like comments and stuff. Yeah, every time Lo posts a video, I give him a thumbs down because I don't agree with what he said about annoying. He could have did it a different way.
It's probably one or two niggas who say that. I really don't.
Yeah, that's Willie tried that shit the other day when one person was like, "I hate the editing." And then
it was something because this is very rare where people like make a dedicated tweet to say the editing was bad.
No, that's not, at least not for me.
Oh, I just thought like, because at first I thought he was gonna say somebody replied with it. I was like, oh, okay.
Nah, and then Willie said it like at least four times over the next few days. He's like, people were saying the editing was bad in the video.
A lot of people.
A whole bunch of people.
I think one person on Twitter.
Literally, we might just be walking around and we might pass by one another. He's like, man, that last video Adrian uploaded, a lot of people just said it just wasn't fucking with it. Yeah. We'd be grilling outside. He's like, man, just flip a patty. Man, that last video, man, a lot of people weren't fucking with that one, bro. And we'll be asking, like, so what do you mean?
He's just like,
and he's like, you see this one tweet right here?
What does it say?
What does this one tweet say? And then you'd be like, so anyone else? Man, I'm telling you, there's a lot of people right there, bro.
But there's a consensus. Lot. I only know of one, but there's plenty of.
So like, I'm gonna start screenshotting the hate and sending it to y'all. But I promise you, somehow I was like, yeah, that's low. I just don't fuck with him.
But most people, I didn't feel like I actually got that much hate for it, because actually annoying TV got a lot more hate, I felt like.
And then I even saw his response to it. That was the only time I ever watched a video of his, because I don't fuck with that shit.
You're not on Naughty Gang?
Yeah, you're not
for annoying TV?
Mm.
Hell no.
Mm. That's tough. Bro, he actually been grinding on Twitch recently, so I fuck with him on that. But yeah, the YouTube shit is kind of OD.
Word. Yeah, the whole Twitch scene for 2K just in general is popping off OD right now.
Nobody got anything else to do. I applaud y'all for having damn, I'm finna say real content, but real content during this lockdown, as opposed to just over streams and, you know, different things like that. I appreciate that.
I'm gonna start over streaming it. I'm gonna just start uploading bullshit.
That's what a lot.
If I upload at least 10 videos and only get like 20,000 views, that's 200,000 views tallying up. So
do y'all follow Flight? And I fuck with Flight videos. All of a sudden, Flight uploads like 6 times a day. I don't know if you.
I know
that's not anything new though. I'm actually surprised OSN has gone down.
Yeah, most
because OSN used to be like
that's the most bullshit.
OSN in his prime used to be uploading like 10 videos a day,
bro. Like you just wake up in the morning, spend a few hours reacting to like 10 videos because you just run. Yeah, there's actually no editing required.
None.
You know, no
OBS start, OBS stop,
and which is so annoying that I'm realizing that right now.
No editing, and you know, I've watched Flight, for whatever reason. I'm watching his stuff now, and he'll look at the screen just with his little face like this, and then he might make two reactions throughout the whole video.
Yes,
that's some of the worst content I've ever seen in my goddamn.
That's bad.
Yes,
no, it's not bad, bro. Because if he's reacting to everything, then it's not real. You're not gonna have a huge reaction to everything.
I'd rather him than don't upload it. I don't want to see you. I don't want to sit there and watch you.
He wouldn't know it's a bad upload until he got. He wouldn't know it's a bad reaction until he got done recording it. But once he gets done recording it, he's not going to not upload it.
That's the dumbest thing ever. That's dumb as hell.
Because he's already.
Yeah, there's gonna be some reactions I do where I'm not.
But you're not going to upload it.
There's plenty of reactions I've done I haven't uploaded.
And I know he knows it too. There's some of these videos that he watches where it's the same clips. Like he might watch a video Monday and then that Wednesday video, it's the same clips from the Monday video.
Yeah, for sure, for sure.
And he might have a reaction. He might not have a reaction. Like Monday he's seen the clip and then Wednesday he'll have a reaction. That's bullshit.
Yeah, I don't really watch his reaction video. I more so watch him on stream.
But he's way more Nody Gang for me, so
he's definitely more funny on, like he's way
blowing up your stream. Phone.
Yeah,
imagine me on Nody Gang with OSN or Flight. That's like, definitely what? Like just on some. I know you're going to upload today, so I'm just going to scroll on the channel. Cause I don't.
Oh, you only get 3 noties a day, though.
Are you serious?
Yeah, they don't give you more than 3 noties a day on YouTube.
But I think that's a lot.
If you do a community post, a stream, and a video, the next thing you do in that 24 hours is not going to get a notie.
Oh, you're talking about for individual channels?
Yeah.
I thought you meant like as someone who receives them.
I think he has 2 channels, though, so he gets 6. Total. I think he has like Flight Reacts.
Right. Fully capitalized.
And not Flight Reacts. Yeah. And I want to know the gang for both of them.
Imagine if he does a community post on his second channel saying, hey, y'all uploaded like 2 more videos. I know y'all didn't get this, so I'm going to go over there and go watch that, bro.
But they wouldn't get the community post neither.
What do you mean?
Because you're telling the community post is to tell people about the videos they didn't know about.
What do you mean?
Okay, bro, if you run out after 3... and you're doing a community post to tell people to watch it on the second channel. Oh, on the other channel.
To say
the
first channel to say.
That's not a bad idea. That's a good way to promo, actually.
I uploaded 3 more videos.
In case.
Now, I know y'all not going to get those
45 more minutes.
Yeah.
I respect it, though, bro.
Is that bullshit content?
And he got his first Broly.
The fake. Yeah, bro? I saw the first. Oh, he spent 20 minutes talking about his first Broly.
It's a flooding.
God damn.
20 minutes, boy. Oh, my God. I watched all of it. I don't know why. That bullshit, the fake. Oh, I pranked the pranks have gone up way more than usual.
Oh, well, them niggas is trash.
And then I guess, I don't know if y'all got smoke with them, but I don't care. The bullshit that 2 Hype be putting out.
Oh, man.
Take your glasses off.
Sexy is bright out. I have migraines.
And let me say this.
This nigga behind the scenes is going to be like, yo, cut this whole part.
No, don't cut this whole part. And let me say this. If they been spending this whole quarantine doing this bullshit, and the first video they don't submit afterwards, when everything is cleared up, is the NBA 2K, or NBA, not NBA, shit, basketball YouTube showdown challenge, the 5v5, if they don't immediately upload that, then everybody needs to unsubscribe to them. They spent the whole lockdown. The whole lockdown.
Well, you talking about LSK and Cash?
Like LSK, Cash, Jesser. Everybody made this list. Like, this was at the beginning of the lockdown. Oh, who's the best?
Oh, that.
That's what I play on YouTube. So then they spent like 2, 3, 4 weeks doing reactions to the list and making their own list. And then now they're
the
back
wildest
to
shit in the world.
Wildest lane. Terrible. And so then now they're filling it up with just whatever bullshit they got going on. If the first video they don't drop after that,
as a collective is them doing a meetup and settling these lists. Everybody needs to unsubscribe to them. Period.
You got any input?
Take your glasses off.
Any input?
Take your glasses off.
Agent Zero. You got any input?
Take your non-prescription
glasses. I actually didn't keep up with all the lists and stuff, so I don't actually.
What you got with the LSK? Because we talked about
I'm not
it.
In tune with what's going on, you know, on that side.
Shout out to LSK.
Would you hear what the LSK list, you know, we talked about on the podcast?
Oh, I remember LSK's list. It was horrible. Yeah,
yeah, LSK.
Oh, why was it horrible?
Because he was just very wrong.
He put the biggest moment to me was he put what's my nigga name? Fuck,
Davis.
Yeah, Davis. He put Davis below Flight, and I was like, off rip, it's invalid. your whole list is invalid as soon as you put Davis below Flight.
Yeah, I think that needs to be the first video.
And Davis is straight. Davis is straight at basketball.
Yeah. Davis is better than Flight. Well, Flight got a trainer. So in about 2 months,
he's still better.
In about two months,
he has a few days.
Like I said, I'm Noti Gang. I've been seeing Flight work. I don't know.
No, Flight is. I mean, Davis is better than Flight. Yeah, that's not even a question.
Okay,
that's not. That's not really a question.
Flight or Curry?
Stop.
At what? Reacting?
Basketball. I think Curry said he don't like Flight. I think there's beef. Real beef.
There might be because.
Oh man, you're real active now. When we were talking about the two-like thing, you got a little quiet.
Oh, no, I just wanted to let you guys get your input, and I felt like I was talking too much this podcast.
Okay.
Okay, but now we're pointing to you. So what do you feel about the two-like thing?
As I said earlier, I just didn't keep up with it.
Okay. We'll tell it about, you know.
I might have to cut that out, too, because niggas are going to be like, y'all hate on two-hype.
No, and let them know. I don't hate on two-hype, whatever, two-flight, I was going to say. I fuck with LSK.
Yeah,
that's it. How about the rest of the guys?
LSK crazy.
Cash
who?
Oh, stop! Please stop.
And nah,
Cash is your type of nigga though.
No, he's not.
Yeah, he is.
I don't want to be mean because I really don't. I don't even want to start. You know, my content creation career. Hold on, that's me prefacing the meanness. I don't want to start my content creation career like that. If Cass didn't lisp, I just can't hear the lisping and the mispronunciation of words and stuff like that.
But then Flight does that too, though.
Flight is fine. So.
No, Jesus Christ. Shout out to Your Rage. That's a nigga I be watching religiously, too. Your Rage is on some other shit. That shit is hilarious. Your Rage and Los and occasionally Flight as well on Twitch. That's what I've really been doing, just being on Twitch a lot. Deadass.
You don't watch Tysino? Or no?
I actually do, yeah. I watch Tysino too sometimes when you wager.
I don't watch Twitch 2K that much.
So who have you been watching during the quarantine lockdown?
I don't watch a lot of stuff. I get depressed when I watch too much streams. So you know, I try and keep it videos first, you know.
So I'm saying whose videos have you been watching and whose content don't you like?
You know, I be watching Philip DeFranco every day.
Philip DeFranco?
You know what I'm saying? Philip DeFranco every day, bro.
And you don't like his content?
Who, Philip?
Yeah.
Not Philip.
So talk about the content you don't like. Take your glasses off too.
Hey. No, it's because it's mad bright out.
What's up? Why you don't want the smoke?
I don't talk shit though, bro.
It's not talking shit, and that's the thing. It's not talking shit. That was the thing. That's the thing I didn't understand about the annoying TV thing. It's constructive criticism. And if you want somebody to DM to you, that's fine.
Bro, there is such a large plethora of garbage content. In fact, I say majority of content is garbage.
Thank you.
So then, what am I gonna do about it? I just watch it, laugh because it's bad, and then move on. But you know, it's so bad though that it's fucking great.
Yeah, sometimes it's so bad it's actually funny.
I'd rather watch a bad video than a mediocre video. Mediocre video, then I'm like,
that's actually a fact.
Dry. This is dry as fuck right now. Give me that horrible video with like 6 minutes of black screen, absolutely zero content. You know, the cuts is all fucked up. The audio is left and right, man.
Not even mediocre. I'll go as far as saying I would rather watch a really bad video than a like okay video or good video.
Word.
To be honest.
Really?
If we were putting it in order, I would watch like a damn near perfect video first, then like a really, 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 really good video, and then right after that, bad videos. Like if you can just give me like a really bad video, because I find way more humor in that.
You agree?
For sure. Good and then above average before very bad videos. Because very bad videos, you have to watch with people. It's not as fun when you watch it alone.
Oh, just to laugh at it.
It's depressing when you watch it
with people. Yeah, very depressing.
Oh, yeah. Shout out to Soul Illuminati too.
Oh, for sure.
You know, talking about depression, Omar, you're depressed. You know, I'm not here to be your therapist or anything like that, but you did mention earlier that you were a CS major. And we know that everybody that engages in computer science is thoroughly depressed. So what do you do to fight through that depression?
Serious advice first. If there's any CS majors out there, anybody going through that type of work, close your laptop. Sometimes you just got to close your laptop. For real. Close your laptop, move away from the computer. It'll definitely help you.
And pick up your iPad and start to get to work.
No, watch something. Close your laptop. It'll clear your mind. Other than that, I
forgot CS majors don't have Apple products, exclusively Android.
He has Apple.
I have Apple. I have a Mac and everything.
Largely speaking.
And what's crazy is I'm gonna have to buy a real computer too. Wow.
Didn't a real say. Computer. Yeah, excuse me, sir. Technology 2020. This is a real computer.
I'm a real avid Twitter troll, so I love to troll on Twitter. That's my way.
You know, they're trying to get rid of y'all.
Yeah, but it's not, you know.
They're trying really hard to get rid of y'all,
man. And they can't. But it's not like crazy Twitter trolls. I might start the LeBron MJ thing, or I might start something stupid. Like I tweeted the other day, if you have three bodies as a woman, you might as well have 1,000. So I might go off of something like that, but I'm not.
So, like, let's do some hypotheticals. You know, Aisha Curry was trending this morning.
She's a clown.
And you're a Twitter troll. What's your first move?
My Twitter troll is to definitely bring up the clips of her. First of all, she looked hungry. Let's talk about that. Second of all, I would bring up the clips of her slandering women from back in the day about being nude and stuff like that.
Which is the crazy shit.
And then her also talking about how the game six was rigged, or whichever game they lost, the Warriors lost, was rigged. And then fuck Steph Curry song.
Do you? Huh?
No, I would try to figure out, like, wait, the whole, like, I'm seeking for validation or attention from other men, even though I'm in a relationship.
That, but you know what's crazy?
She's not in a relationship. She's married.
That was honest, though, Lo. A lot of women think that, but they'll never say it. But she said it publicly. That's honest. It's fucked up.
Yeah, it is.
But I kind of rated her for just saying that still.
I forgot about that. And every day she's starting to look more and more like Steph with the wig on. So I'd probably go there, too. You asked what I would do as a troll.
I wonder what Steph Curry thinks about all this. Because I know he has to publicly, like, defend his girl.
I don't think he cares.
I definitely think Steph is the type of dude that doesn't ever want to go home. You know what I mean? That's like trying to, like, he's literally like, Clay, yo, you want to get some more shots up or something like that? Dre, let's run this pick and roll one more time.
Steve Kerr, what's that? We watching film?
How much, like, can we watch more film? I got to work on my golf swing.
Hold on, I brought a hard drive. Let's put some film on here for the home.
Now, most of y'all don't know this, but I draw inspiration from 70s basketball, so that's where this film is from. Like, yeah, I really think Steph Curry's like that.
But he was watching the commercials, too.
If Steph doesn't retire until he's, like, 43 and he has to get carried off the court, then you might have something going on right there.
Nah, he had too many knee problems up front for that to be the case.
No, he might just be like a player coach, like, hey, yo, just put me in the last 5 seconds and I'll just knock down the corner.
He's definitely going to start coaching out. He doesn't want to go home.
Yo, what if he immediately transitioned to coaching? Like, as soon as he retired, he was like, I'm a head coach.
And I feel like he could successfully accomplish that. You know, I'm worried about, like, what point in his career he's going to become Steve Novak. You know what I'm saying?
Steve Novak.
That's a fact.
I feel like he's going to get there maybe, like, at age 35, 36. He might become Steve Novak.
Chill.
Steve Novak.
Whatever it is, he won't be going home to his wife. Babe, I cooked again, this time topless. Oh, my God. Just stop.
Yo, I guarantee, that's the wildest shit in the world.
I guarantee you. And I'd be willing to put some money on this. You know how on your phone, if you don't have the number saved, it'll say maybe so-and-so?
Yeah, yeah, likely.
Her name is maybe Aisha Curry in his phone. Like, he doesn't have her number saved. I swear he doesn't.
Someone on Twitter was like, I hope she doesn't have Face ID.
Yeah, that was... No. That was to...
It was to both of them.
It was Khloe.
Yeah, it was to both of them.
The Khloe Kardashian dude is hilarious.
Hey, shout out to her, though, for losing weight.
No,
that is a shout out.
It's an accomplishment to raise enough money to have surgery.
A lot of people said it might be surgery, but regardless, you know, congratulations on having the money. Congratulations on having the money to do the surgery.
Structure change. What are you talking about?
Hey, you know, no, but so yo, when I lose weight, you're gonna see, like, my face is gonna look very different too.
Boy, you ain't finna have no surgery face.
Her whole chin.
Okay, but I don't know shit about surgery.
She has pictures when she's younger, and she used to have like a a thicker chin. Her chin structure has changed. Yeah.
I hate that people feel like they had to change their look to be accepted.
Oh, man. And she's not one of those people because she was highly successful.
But I think sometimes people say things because they want to believe it. And I think a lot of what she was saying, like mid-2010s, was she just wanted to believe those things because it was too uncomfortable to go on living for that not to be the case. Like she would say, like, she had a tweet about how.
Get off the internet. What the fuck is wrong with her?
I don't know what's good with her, bro. I don't know, but shout out Stephen Curry, man. Cause he hasn't made a mistake in his career in a very long time. You know what I'm saying? The only drama he's ever been in was being associated with his wife.
Whoa.
That's true.
No,
it's like LeBron. LeBron literally had no drama up until China comments. He almost went a whole career with zero fucking drama. That shit is incredible.
The only mistake Steph Curry, I don't know about the decision when he threw the party in Miami before they even played a practice. And they ended up losing that same year.
Oh, no, that was the clown.
Going to Miami is a setup.
Six. I don't know if you ever seen that video, like, recently. Not six, not seven. Yeah, no, that was the most clown thing ever.
The biggest mistake that Curry's done was that behind the back pass in 2016. He threw the ball out of
bounds. That was tragic.
Yeah. Like, I was like, really? Right now? This is what you... Like right now, and you can see it in Klay Thompson's face. He was like, "Fuck, bro!" Like,
at this moment,
we doing this. Holy fuck! God damn, man, I'm just trying to peel off, get an easy look, and you going behind passing, the back.
Please. I actually saw an incredible ad from Nike, and it like encompassed like all their athletes. It was on Instagram, and it was like, "Never count yourself out." Look at that mad generic caption, but it was that moment when LeBron. No one's ever came back from 3-1. Now someone's going to have to come back from 3-0 to be the greatest of all time.
Apparently they're not the greatest of all time. So,
who, LeBron?
I think LeBron is the greatest.
No, let's not get into that. Come on.
No. But I'm just letting you know. I just let you know how
I feel. Let me put these on. Hold on.
He's definitely not the greatest of all time. But
I'm tired of defending you in the comments, too, of your Twitter tweets.
You don't have to. Even though what you said today was completely correct, because the niggas are just stupid about that Carmelo Anthony thing.
Tired of defending you.
And people say, I say just factual things, and they be like, oh, you don't have to hate on him. I'm like, I'm not. I'll literally say, no knock on Melo. And they'd be like, yo, you don't have to hate. I'm like, damn, nigga, I said it.
People think like criticism is hate. You know what I'm saying?
But it wasn't your, it was just me acknowledging
back to
something.
My too hype stuff. Oh, no, you're right. You're right.
You good? No, I was just thinking about how like people genuinely think that Carmelo Anthony is a top 50 player.
You think he is too, because you don't know 50 players in NBA history to put over him. So yeah, you do. You think he is?
Oh, we definitely have to put Jamal Mashburn,
Gilbert Arenas.
Stop, please.
Oh, we going there?
That would be the most disrespectful shit in the world. When nigga put Jamal Mashburn ahead of Carmelo. Yo, I'll be pissed if I was Carmelo.
Speedy Claxton. Oh, no. All them boys.
Oh yes, sir. Who's that Giambo? One guy who like had a couple good games coming out the D League from Utah? Is a point guard.
Sunday out of games?
Yes, sir. Put him right out there, too.
No, Sunday out of games. He gave LeBron that work. That's the first time.
One game. He had a game winning all
that.
That
doesn't matter. If you ask Skip Bayless, it doesn't matter. Mm. So,
what about that Doja Cat situation?
You have to explain that to me. I didn't keep up with that.
Doja Cat is a racially ambiguous artist. Racially ambiguous meaning you could like, if you looked at him, you wouldn't necessarily know what their race is. Like, offer. Like, you would know I'm black. But if you look at Doja Cat,
what is with agent?
It's because you guys lack culture,
right? So maybe he's probably racially ambiguous. Okay.
No, you guys lack culture. Anyone could look at me and go East African immediately, except
nobody,
y'all.
Nobody. Black. Not with those
nobody
glasses.
Nobody would say that. Yeah, not with those glasses.
How about now?
But so she was on you know, different streams, Twitch. I think it was Twitch. It was, you know, a bunch of
it was something else. I can't remember what it was, but it wasn't Twitch. It was some weird ass stream.
She was on some weird ass stream where you could see like a bunch of people, almost like Google Party or something like that. Yeah. I don't know. But she was in there with some incels and some white supremacists. And
why were they together?
And she was going nuts. And she's openly come out and had like anti-black comments. Mind you, she's black by definition. White definition, of course, but by definition. And she's just a clown. She's just a clown. But that goes to my theory that I tweeted another day. Women are clowns.
Just as that's a theory?
As a general
statement. What kind
name six women you know that aren't clowns. You can't.
Mm,
so, and we don't.
I'm pretty sure I can.
You can. And we don't have to go there because you got your glasses on. I know you don't want to call out any women that you know are clowns, but.
No, there's plenty of people in general. Yeah,
I'm saying in general, it don't matter if women or not.
No. I agree. Dudes can be clowns too. Women are clowns, just as a general statement.
Like all of them? Man, who hurt you?
Do y'all have a high women audience?
Who hurt you?
Do we have a high women audience?
Yeah, like what's the demographic?
Are they analytics to you? God damn.
I'm saying, what's the, I don't want to offend, you know, I'll save those comments for my channel.
No, we don't have no women that
for
watch.
For my channel.
Oh, okay, yeah. Women.
I said that in one of my main channel videos. I was like, oh, because you guys are all guys, right? The top comment was just like a bunch of girls like, hey, right here.
Jeez.
Shout out to shout out to them. I fuck with girls. Love them.
You fuck with girls? You said that shit like you really don't, but you need to backtrack a little bit.
I do. Ain't no backtracking. Women are clowns.
Well, who hurt you? Why do you believe that?
Women are clowns. Lie on this podcast and say women are clowns.
I have.
You definitely ran across women who are clowns.
That I deem to be clowns. That's true.
You know what's clownery? The whole wipe down challenge, this thing right here?
Some people can't edit a video.
Where they can't edit at all. Well, they'll just like, they're supposed to wipe down and it's supposed to flip and it doesn't flip until they get like halfway through the thing. And it's like, what are you doing right now?
Wow, that's just bad editing.
Exactly.
Someone needs to get her a Sony Vegas class.
She just doesn't care. Like, she just believes that people are cleaning the mirror. Like, she don't get the concept of like.
And the mirrors the be smeared and all that shit afterwards, too. That's some clown shit.
But hey, man, you know, it's a net positive.
Oh, yeah, we need the Doja Cat thing. So then she got on the thing. She got on the stream and was like being very open about like what she preferred sexually.
Mm.
And she was saying like how she wants like a white man. She prefers older white men and she wants a white man to call her the N-word.
Hard R.
That's what she what was her sarcasm levels looking like?
No, she's serious.
To be honest with you, she's like, she's more on a drunk side than being sarcastic. But she was very serious because she said that before.
What the fuck?
She said that like it was another clip where I think she was painting and she said that she likes like feet and being stepped on. And then the guy was like, is this like a foot fetish thing? He's like, no, it's like more of a dominant thing.
So now you can't, anybody who's like prospectively looking into, you know, getting a relationship with her can't, because we're immediately going to assume he says the hard R.
That is a fact.
I know you say the hard R.
Not even assume. I know that's because I know that's what your woman likes. So you're definitely out here saying the hard R.
Plus, he probably wants to say it.
Oh, that's why I said she's trying to date incels and white supremacists. That's what was in the chat. She is actively searching for incels and white supremacists.
And she was like going, she was moaning into the mic. She was doing like but she came across a bit tipsy. To be honest with you though, I don't really think I care that much.
Me neither.
No. People are like, you're canceled, Doja Cat. And I'm like, I don't really think I care.
I
like,
can if only that's, name one Doja Cat. Oh, I can name two Doja
no,
Cat.
No, I can name songs. Actually, name three that I actually really like.
Like from SoundCloud Doja Cat or like?
No, original? Like recently.
I know the Moo song and the Say
The
so.
Moo song is the only one I know. Omar, talking about sexual preferences, you know, what kind of men or women are you into?
I'm glad you kept it open, Dwayne Wade. what are you?
And when you answer that? I told him the other day, I was like, this is where I get my troll shit. Like, we be in the house trolling each other all day. He don't be believing me.
Well, I remember, look, I used to go in Marcel's room and just, oh, my fault. I used to go in Lowe's room. No, I used to go in Lowe's room and just, I mean, off rip. It could be like a long day or whatever. Hey, mind if I come in as the door is open? And off rip. Yeah, man, I just been thinking, you know, my life is getting a little tough. I've been really thinking about ending it all. And then I'll say, yeah, because I don't want Netflix anymore. So I might just end all of those subscriptions and transfer over to Hulu. So, yeah, you just troll all day. So you just got to stay trolling. So back to Dwayne Wade. Women.
Can you take off your glasses? This is so unprofessional. You can see your eyes.
My bad. I just prefer them on.
Women, of course. Well, not of course, but women and, you know, black women.
I feel
women.
Like this is a layup of a question, by
I
the
like,
way.
I like black women, you know.
Okay, interesting.
Black child, you know.
Like what kind, though? Like,
what you
like, describe her to me.
With feet? Like,
what? Well, obviously.
I like.
Figure they're humans.
I like small women, except for Meg Thee Stallion. I would definitely get into that type of woman, big woman. I wouldn't, like I said, 5 inch. I wouldn't know what to do with her, but Definitely a Meg Thee Stallion type.
Definitely need to have a fucking, like a ruler with that fat ass. Like, it's got to be ridiculous.
Something like that.
Jesus Christ.
But I like petite women, you know. I like the dark-skinned women's. And I like them with a little aggression in them.
Like a, you like to be dominated?
Not on no Doja Cat type stuff, but yeah, I do like to be dominant. And not on no Paul Pierce, I'm a spit.
You like
on
to be
somebody.
Dominated or you like to be dominant?
No, he said like to be, you said like to be dominated?
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Not on no, like dominated. Like, I don't want to be Doja Cat in a situation where somebody's stepping on me, calling me the hard R. And I don't want to be Paul Pierce where somebody's spitting on me. So.
So what do you mean by that?
I just want her to be, if she might, you know, I want to hear shut the fuck up sometimes. Like, oh, babe, what you want to eat? Shut the fuck up. Oh. I guess you're not hungry. I'm going to come back
that's
later.
That's not being dominated, though.
So you'll be verbally abused. I see what you're saying.
I mean, that's the stuff that math turns you on. Being verbally abused turns you on. I don't know.
Yeah, no, that's not being dominated, though. Yeah, you just
want to
be
stepped
on. I don't want to be stepped on.
That's just like someone who's assertive.
Yeah, aggressive and assertive.
That's I don't want to be stepped on.
Or just playful. That's really just playful.
But it's being aggressive, being playful. Because like being playful, there's different ways to be playful. But you want to be a more aggressive playful, yeah.
If she's telling me to shut the fuck up. Oh, shout out to Peter, too. I didn't think I liked Peter.
Why?
I just, his fate. Not even to be funny for real though. He has like a, like if I ever seen his face, like in a setting, like in a room or whatever, I wouldn't be, like he wouldn't be the first one. Like, I think he seems like a guy I would fuck with. I would actually go in the opposite direction. But after watching the pod, I fuck with Peter.
Wow. Look,
that's good. That's good.
Oh, that's aside. I fuck with the, yeah, he's cool.
All right.
And same with Davis too.
Nah,
I used to think I didn't fuck with Davis like that. But I fuck with Davis.
I don't fuck with him still.
What's your
you fuck with Davis? Shut up.
Yeah, he does fuck with Davis.
He was with him the other night.
What's your
that's how y'all watching Pokemon 2000 too. But go ahead, ask me the question.
The shit that he the one who put me on to that too. That
and didn't give me any you know. And this is what I'm talking about right here. Let me get this off my chest.
And that was the cringiest shit I've ever seen in my life.
I give him the material, and he makes it palatable, but still. I just don't get it. Well, I don't know.
Where's the royalties, man?
There is no royalties.
I just want to, yo, shout out to my, this came directly off my brother's brain meets.
That's shout very, very rarely happened. Because I put you on to way more stuff than you put me on the things.
That's a lie. I put him on a 2K.
That literally couldn't happen. If you didn't have a PlayStation, how could that happen?
I ain't put you on a 2K.
How can you just say you don't have a PlayStation? How's that possible?
When we first had the PS3, you were a live guy.
I was a live guy too, actually.
You were a live guy. And nothing wrong with being a live guy.
Live 09, live 10, I left.
Nothing wrong with being a live guy.
Basketball. I just went to Madden and started playing Madden way more often.
And that's when I said to him, dog, 2K's got the best. Like, this is it. And I don't think he really came over until Kobe was on the cover.
No, I played 2K11.
Yeah, I don't think he came
that's
over.
That's 2K10,
till,
yeah.
Yeah. Oh, 2K10.
Yeah, I don't think he came over until Kobe was on the cover. But you were a live guy.
No, who's
for
on
sure.
Who's what's
10.
So what's before Kobe?
KG or Shaq?
KG, yeah.
KG, yeah.
I played KG, yeah. I have.
Oh, I mean, you've played it before. I can't debate that. All the 2Ks are over there. But you were a live guy, and that's okay.
But we all grew up a live guy, but I actually stopped playing live, like, basketball. I stopped playing basketball games after NBA Live 06.
And so how'd you transition to 2K? Me?
No.
What was the question you were going to ask?
Cause you're just lying right now.
I'm not.
Oh, your Sim story. Cause before we, cause I want to forget that. Cause we're already over an hour 15. I know AJ wants to wrap this up as soon as.
Yeah, he keeps putting it on me, y'all. Y'all peep game now, though, right?
He just sent me a text.
Love you one to end shits.
He sent me a text saying, "Yo, hurry, wrap this up."
Yeah. Have I touched my phone though? Rewind it. Have I touched my phone? I have no notifications.
The 680 story or another Sim story?
I don't know what that is.
The 680 story was a story I told on your second channel where I gave the girl rent.
Okay.
Girl, that was a lie. So give us a real story.
That wasn't no lie. I should have brought the Cash App pictures. But
Cash App was. Is this recent, my guy? Because Cash App is not.
This was earlier this year. This was earlier this year.
So you have your phone though. Cash App is on your phone.
I'll pull it up. No, but I'm saying
Cool.
No, I'm serious. I did. Okay, but I'm not finna sit here. Please believe me, I'm a simp.
Imagine a nigga fighting for his right to be called
a simp. Biggest simp in the room. Put me anywhere. The biggest simp in the room.
You're in a room with Legend of Simping.
And let me say this, because I think Phantom was saying it. Or somebody, can you simp to your girlfriend?
Yes.
Legend of simping.
It's while she your girlfriend or like before leading up to your girlfriend?
Just answer both of them then.
While she's leading up, yeah, you definitely can. When she's your girlfriend, I don't think so, because at that point you're just a cuck.
No, bro, that's a simp.
Because a simp specifically is you're giving off the energy and effort and she's not reciprocating it. But if y'all are in a relationship, then technically, yeah.
Oh my gosh, then I have a bunch of those stories.
That means you're a cuck then.
And I'm definitely legend of cucking. You like
but yo, chill, Mo. God damn it, Mo. In loving memory.
Wow. Let's get a new frame. So a simp story. I've done, you know.
Kobe.
Oh my God.
Man, we're 0-5.
What year is this? That was the Utah Jazz misses?
Excuse me, he almost shot 50% that game.
I think you airballed a couple of them too.
Yeah, he airballed two of them.
Utah Jazz game.
Woo! So I've done like, I don't know, spent a like full days when I've been like super busy or had like a deadline, like a school assignment was due, and I kept telling her like, oh, you know, nah, I don't have nowhere to be. I can, you know, I can do X, Y, and Z for you. I can set this up for you. I can this, that, and the third for you. You know, it's no big deal. And then was definitely like late on an assignment or late on paying something or something like that. Cause, you know, you think you got the opportunity to get some cheeks, but
ultimately. Yeah, she don't let you on.
That's what it is. And that's my problem with women right there. They're never up front, you know?
I mean, that's just most people, but women too.
You want to put your sunglasses back on so we can slander these women?
Oh, wow.
But no, I've definitely done that. I've definitely,
But it's not like a particular, what you call it? Like
story.
Yeah.
Recently. Oh my gosh. This is legend.
Recently, man.
This is legend of simping junior. So I jailbreak fire sticks. Can you say that on here? Because that's illegal.
Allegedly, obviously.
Allegedly. Yeah. So
fire. You said that shit like it was your occupation.
Fire stick.
Allegedly. But
so for sure, I was practicing on this one young woman, and she's a ting, you know, an older one. You know?
A ting.
She's got a nice occupation. I ain't gonna put her out there on blast like that. You feel me? I don't fuck with her to this day, but so she had me jailbreak a couple of fire sticks, supposedly for her. And then she said, "Oh yeah, my homeboy wants a fire stick jailbroken for him," and I said, "Oh well." It's not free for him, so we're going to have to do the invoice for him. And she said, oh, okay, well, you know, I'll let him know. So, but then she came back and said, oh, yeah, I just got one more for you to jailbreak. Me, sent me. Mm. Let me just jailbreak another one for her. It wasn't for her.
She lied.
So then, just like the rent situation, I tried to bang her math. No response after I got the jailbroken fire stick to her.
Bang your math means call her phone number.
Yeah, I was hitting her up FaceTime, text, call. I've definitely got the quadruple text in my phone. Hey, just checking on you. Hi, how you been?
Oh, wow.
How you been?
Yeah, no, that's a simp right there. Yeah. Making it a quadruple text and no reply in between.
How's the fire stick working for you? Stuff like that.
You enjoying it? What are you watching? Right
yeah,
now?
What are you watching? I even sent her a couple recommendations and I just didn't hear anything. But I know for a fact.
She'd be like, actually, I do it for free now. So if you need me to.
I know for a fact she gave the most recent fire stick to the guy, her homeboy. Mm. Because she only's got two TVs. She had me jailbreak 4 fire sticks. So.
She was just being.
She got dual monitor.
Yeah, unless she was.
You got dual monitor set up?
Dual fire stick in it.
That's crazy, actually. You can just go to one HDMI port and then the other one on your TV.
But what's the point? So she was definitely.
That's a crazy flex. I got two fire sticks in my shit.
Had to do. I've learned my lesson. You know, I was younger.
You said it was early this year.
Yeah, this has been a long lockdown. I'm not going to hold you. So.
So how does Omar find women in this lockdown, man?
Oh.
Because he needs help with that.
Oh, you need help with finding women?
Yeah.
Nah, actually.
I think you're too famous to find women, you know. Cause I would put you up there on the category of like a Will Smith. I'm serious. I think I understand what your gripe is. I know. Why are you laughing?
Jesus.
Now, what's your type of woman? Because Wally brings all the East African things over here. You know, the Jones.
I don't even know if you can say all that.
Yes, you can. You just said yes, you can.
Okay. Well, mine is like light skin, short, curly hair, smart as fuck, and more ambitious than me. So impossible
to find. So you want a woman like to be with, not for like a night?
No. Why would it? That's.
Okay. So.
Well, you don't.
What?
Why are you looking at me like
what?
That?
What did you just say?
Why are you looking at me
say
like that?
Say what you're going to say.
Nah, I'm not gonna say that shit.
Because it sounds like you want to say something crazy. It sounds like you capping. You did cap. Because,
no, when I do that.
You don't want a girl just for the night? You don't want to just, not maybe not for the night.
In the
but
moment,
just to
fuck. In the moment, that's what I want, but long, like, see what I'm saying? No, that's really just long, a distraction.
What you want right now? You want something for the night? Because I can call everyone's for the night.
No, I definitely don't need you to call nobody. Okay.
You know, Lo got the ones for the night.
Lo, you got something for the night.
Yeah, he showed
but
us
you're that. Not, but he's not going to do that for
me. Oh,
night.
Okay.
I'll do it if you.
No, you're not.
Right.
Condoms or no condoms? Stop with the cap.
No.
No condoms.
Okay, good.
What the hell? No, that was a question.
I'm saying, are you wearing condoms?
Yeah, what the fuck?
Oof, it's a weird life. So let me clarify this. You definitely.
How many kids do you have?
I have zero. And zero pregnancy scares. It's not much for me to pull out, like I said. So. So just to clarify, in your search
can you imagine the reason why she got pregnant was because it took too long for you to pull out? Because your dick was like too fucking long. That's probably someone's situation right now, and I'm laughing.
So to clarify, the woman that you're searching for is not a white woman.
No,
it could be any woman.
What?
Yeah, I don't.
What do you mean?
Now I'd say this.
You mean like for a real relationship or just a smash?
Oh yeah, just in a real relationship. And just in general, my guy, just.
What?
So I'm saying why am I putting restrictions based off race?
Some people have those restrictions. That's
well, I'm saying my preference is light skin, but there's no restrictions.
Okay.
Yeah.
So white women are okay.
Without a doubt. Okay. Not from Georgia though, actually. Because I don't know what it is about white women from Georgia.
Oh, white
but
women.
But
they're
from not like white women from Toronto. I don't know why. I can't explain it to you, bro.
Cold weather. So how you meet women nowadays? First of all, you got the car, because that's all they care about. I think what you should do.
That's so sad, by the way. It doesn't matter. That's what the standard is. Just owning any car.
No, but it's specifically the car you have.
And I'm not trying to.
Oh, you're saying my car?
Yeah, yeah.
Oh.
I'm not trying to make fun of him anymore. I don't think I was making fun of him in the beginning. I didn't mean to say that. But like Annoying TV, he goes to like Neiman's and Bloomingdale's, and he buys all the expensive clothes and stuff. So if you buy more expensive clothes and post up with your car, I think you'll definitely get.
Yeah, but that's if I want to just fuck, though. That's not, like, those are distractions.
So, is that who you you're not talking about that?
What are you talking about?
Are you trying to fuck or not?
No, but that's, like, I can't, bro. I'm trying to try, like, and not say the wrong thing.
Yo, what's wrong with you?
I'm trying not to say the wrong thing.
You're trying to figure out what are you looking for? Are you looking for an actual, are you looking for something long-lasting, a relationship, yeah. Or just to,
well,
like,
no,
fuck
I'm not on. Looking for shit, to be honest with you.
Or just a fuck one. Which one are we talking about?
Yeah, right that now? Question is a fucking setup. So let's talk about
how
Omar.
How is it not?
No.
This is the question that we just around.
Omar, how do you
was that a setup? That is a very simple question.
No, and this I can help you if you tell me right now. Are you looking for the Insta smash?
No, not right now.
So what you looking for? A long term John?
I'm looking for someone that when I'm with them, I'm not losing fucking brain cells.
There's plenty of intellectual women in Atlanta.
Sometimes intellectual women, like
especially with the entrepreneurial spirit, those are the ones that.
No, they're not, bro. I mean, okay, I don't want to say that's cap. There's plenty, but not on dating apps. What I meant to say.
Oh, you got to get off dating apps.
Yeah.
We gotta start going because I think there's places where affluent people go. Now, I feel
that's a fact. When I sit courtside, my guy, I'm telling you, it's a different energy. I just want to
flex, right?
That if sitting courtside is, it's like. $300 in Atlanta. It's not a flex.
It's not $300.
Yeah, it's definitely not $300.
I sat courtside for $180 before.
Yeah, definitely.
What, at a preseason game?
No. At a Hawks game.
What's the WNBA team?
It was, I think it was against the Pacers too. No, the Pacers one was like $300. But they're all mad cheap, bro. So it's not front seat courtside. It's four rows back.
Okay.
It's on the court though. It is courtside. Because you get to go to the free food area and there's a whole lounge for courtside.
So let me say this. So I'm saying, that's the new stadium.
So there was a girl I was talking to. I was sitting beside her conveniently. She came mad late. She said she worked at like some fucking radio show or something. And I was like, oh my. Like for the first time I felt like oh, no, she's definitely about her business. Like, if she told me she was busy, I believe her. Because you know when people are fake busy, and I know it, and I just let it slide? Well, she's like, oh, no, I'm exhausted. Like, I'm like, how do you even get time? Like, I don't know. But that's what she did. She was like a reporter. And I was like, oh, wow, this is incredible. So I get what you're saying.
Why you didn't?
Yeah, that was a mistake. I'm not going to lie to you. Because we were talking the entire game, too.
Oh, yeah.
And she was going out of her way to talk. And this is what she did, bro. No cap. She had her drink right here. And then she just bumped me. And she's like, oh, my bad.
Yeah, you definitely should have.
You should have just gotten
it. You should have linked and built. But the women at those games, most of them are there for the ballers. So you don't, they're gold diggers. And I don't think you like that.
Not from courtside, bro.
Not all the way to courtside.
Yeah, I'm telling you they're not.
There's definitely a section, though.
There's definitely a section. So what I'm saying to you is there's like places by the Brave Stadium and stuff. Like there's affluent women throughout Atlanta that you can, and they have intellectual conversations.
But I'm saying, how do you do that right now, though? Because
through quarantine.
Oh, that's nearly impossible.
Yeah, you probably don't. And let me say this too: stuff is starting to loosen up. So, I mean, we could get out more. Stuff is definitely starting to loosen up. So.
That's a fact.
I don't know if y'all are still scared.
I'm not scared no more. Actually,
not really, no, not really. I'm not as scared as I once was.
I almost went to the mall today, and then I realized somebody fucking.
Well, I'm not doing that though.
But I went there because I needed an Apple charger immediately. But I found out Amazon does one day shipping. So.
Oh, they're back. Okay.
Yeah.
So they're back. Yeah. So listen, with some of the restrictions being lifted, and I feel like some of these people will start to get, you know, out and about more. I feel like we should go to events.
That's what I want to do. I think YouTube parties, but I feel like, you know, it's going to be a lot of opportunistic, as Flight React says, LA bitches there. I want to talk to like a suburban Atlanta person. You know?
That's not a
like,
thing.
Like,
That's an oxymoron.
Suburban, though.
A suburban Atlanta's the city.
He's talking about the
outskirts. Okay, but I'm saying like the suburbs of Atlanta. Like, I want to talk to somebody from the suburbs.
He's on the outskirts.
Those are like older people too, so I don't think they have anything to talk to you about.
I just want to try.
If there's a it depends on what side of town. So I guess it just depends on what side of town.
You know what I would want to see more? And you brought it up. YouTube party. I would want to see y'all do stuff more, and I could see that there's hiccups and everything within that. If y'all were to get together and link more content creators and stuff like that, I feel like you might find the one there.
People are not going to come to Atlanta, which is the weirdest shit in the world, because Atlanta would be the most ideal place to live for a content creator.
I swear to God it is.
They wouldn't come for like a meetup even?
Maybe for a meetup, but it should just be more, because how convenient it is for like Davis or Peter to just come by. It's just that it would make the world of sense. It's a popping enough city for stuff is going on, and on top of that, the living arrangements is really cheap in contrast to a lot of other major cities. Yeah. Like, it just doesn't make any sense why people just don't live in Atlanta.
I don't know how long 2Hype is in their contract for, but
it is kind of harder to find. it is kind of harder to find like big enough housing. Because like here, the whole south side,
the setup is now, Davis doesn't live here. How y'all kind of have y'all own separate houses, but it's still within proximity.
Each other. I just don't know how lucky we'd be able to get. But if you were to try to do another big house, it would be
stuff isn't that far, you know. A 30 minute drive, 40 minute drive for us to do like a thing. I really do feel like y'all should do more. Things not
with,
just
with who though?
Not just like AMP wise, but everybody get together.
But with who though?
Whoever the relevant.
Bro, that's the whole point of the collab room was originally.
But people don't come
because I like doing that.
But people just don't come.
No, because we have the AMP shit every month now, and it does take time because it's like 2 to 3 days we're dedicating to just recording videos. So we only do that twice, three times in a month. We're not gonna have time to do our own channels, and now almost all of us have second channels, and then there's podcasts and then AMP shit, and some of us are streaming. So it should adds up.
So, but what if it's like a once every 2 months or 3 month thing? Like once every 3 months, big YouTube link up, and we might do. Y'all did the marathon video, and I really think that was pretty cool. Like last one, I know this is like an older concept, but last one to stay on.
Yeah, that 2K. That was money. That was a money video.
But if it's like as opposed to it was like 8 people. What if it was 30 people? And well, it might not be
the
that
logistics
many.
Would be impossible.
But if there was a way for it to work, I feel like
it would take too much planning. I'd literally have to hire somebody to plan something like that because I refuse to coordinate with 30 people.
But if you want to get the biggest videos, you got to go bigger. Am I wrong?
Nah, not necessarily, bro. Because in that last Play 2K video, I already got the biggest. Like Troy was there, Davis was there, Phantom was there. Like we already had entertaining people. Boom. Like I don't think there's more entertaining people I could have added to make that video better. It would have just made the video more. It wouldn't have made it better. It would have made it more.
So drawing from more audiences, though. I'm saying and I'm just talking purely numbers. If you want to get the biggest video, wouldn't you need to just make the video bigger in that sense?
Nah,
that's not how it works.
Nah. Oh. You just need to clickbait better.
Yeah.
Oh well, yeah. Nowadays. That's literally. So okay, that's what you could do. Last to play 2K, and I reveal my OnlyFans link.
If I ever did a OnlyFans, that would be a hilarious concept. I need to do an OnlyFans, but with like Party City outfits.
And on top of that, the only way
that shit would be fire, yo.
I heard what he said. Just ignore what he was saying.
What about like not the slutty ones though?
If you the thing is this though, if you which call it
just
though,
generic ones.
If you what is this shit called? If you made it like a thing to do, because like that's why I think they should have made the. And also, okay, here's something we got to talk about off camera because I brought it up in the last video.
Damn.
We didn't talk about it. But there's.
See, this is why you're holding the pod back, Lo.
I don't think you want me to say it. Because then it's a great idea. And I don't think you want it.
Wait, what are you referring to?
Say it and cut it out.
I don't want to cut it out.
Okay, never mind.
I'll say it then.
Hey, don't spoil my ideas, bro.
No, it was actually my idea. And then you said, hold on, we might have to cut that out for a second.
I'll say it.
You remember that?
It's my idea now.
Shut the fuck up. Anyway, there's ideas that could definitely happen. But I think I agree with you saying it would have to be like a thing. Like people would just have to expect it. Like, oh, it's about to be that time again where something, you know, people drop. But I kind of feel like that's the kind of vibes that AMP is giving right now because they know every Monday.
AMP.
No, and I love AMP. You know, I really do fuck with y'all.
Thanks, man.
Too Hype. Shout out to LSK. No, for real. I fuck with Too Hype. I fuck with. No, stop. I fuck with Too Hype. You know, I watch Kick Jeans. I watch all these some groups.
They broke up a long time ago.
It was recently.
We dead ass. Me and Agent are the dead ass new duo. Dead ass keeping the beat.
Y'all think y'all Kick Jeans? Shout out to Trey. Y'all think they're coming together though. They're coming together. And Jay Jones, that's my name.
I'm keeping it a beam. We'll see. We'll see what happens in another month or two. We'll see.
Yeah, I fuck with Jay Jones. But what I'm saying is just for one video. Have AMP, Too Hype. I don't know no other.
Oh, that's impossible to do.
How is that? Have y'all tried to link up with?
And Too Hype, they have a hard time getting together.
No, and I bet they do.
That's nearly impossible.
I bet they do, but I can only think of how big the video would be.
That's impossible to do.
Yeah, the logistics is. Anytime people are like, "Yo, why don't you guys put together?" Because it's annoying to put together events. It's so annoying because you got to coordinate with people that are busy and a lot of people that are busy. So then it's like you text somebody, but they ain't hear back. But then you don't know if this is guaranteed. Is this for sure yet? This person's down, but this person's not.
Like it's so ridiculous that you would have to literally plan out. If we started planning today, at the earliest, the event wouldn't start until like December. And I'm not even like, that's not even a joke. Like it would be December to almost a whole nother year.
Have y'all for the event? Have y'all tried to do something like that?
No, we just started AMP. We obviously are
trying to get
the foundation right.
Even when you do the videos for the playing the 2K, like 2K for 24 hours, that's not easy. That's not something easy to you can just pop up and do.
I get that. I'm just saying, if we're trying to get
it, man. Plus people cap too. People gonna sit there and say,
"Listen,
oh, I'm coming," and then they don't come.
I get that too.
I
get that all of it happens. We want to see the bangers. We want to see the biggest in the room.
But to be honest with you, that's the reason why they live in
the same house so they can.
No. Well, not just them, but in LA because it makes it easier for them to do that. So instead of like we all getting together at one time, Flight can take the time out to play Cash and one day Jesser and one day. McQueen and then one day DDG like he so can with, just do that
with what you're saying. I'll get the YouTuber basketball list video, but from what you're saying, I probably won't get it because they all can't get together.
No, well, if they live in LA, yes, but like
all of them expect, don't live in LA.
So well, not all of them, but to like expect Davis to play anybody in basketball anytime soon. That's not AMP. That's not gonna happen.
Yeah, there's too many like people doing too many things for that to line up. Even getting one person for my video is hard because
even if he were to go to LA and touch down, the odds that he would be able to just link with somebody immediately and say, "Hey, yo, let's go shoot this video real quick."
Sometimes it's hard to do that.
But no, sometimes
in LA, I don't know enough people in any other city but LA and here.
But sometimes it's still hard to do. Even that is sometimes hard to do. Because if anybody says, "Oh no, I'm actually got a video already, I'm done, I'm trying to record it, I'm about to go over here and do that," if they're busy, then they're not doing it.
Or
especially on a basketball video where it's only going to be one video that y'all uploading on one person channel.
And I feel like, yeah, that would be, I figured that would be the biggest hurdle, what channel you actually uploaded to. As opposed
to this is not like you talking about people. Oh, I thought this was at least on somebody's channel immediately. You talking about like a community channel?
No. And that's what I'm saying. What would you upload it to? Two Hype has their own channel, I'm assuming.
Right? Yeah, but that would be even worse though. Because there's no way a nigga gonna go from LA to Atlanta just so it can't be uploaded on their channel.
But so you would upload it. No, that's not what I'm saying. I'm saying would you upload it on each individual's group channel? So yeah. It would be on the AMP channel. And then it will be on the Two Hype channel, and I'll keep throwing in a third group. It will be on the third group's.
You have to make channel. Enough content for it to be on all three channels.
Which would be yeah, even so the more people do. You add, the more people that want to record, and then yeah. The more it gets complicated.
That's what I figure would be the biggest hurdle. I feel like linking isn't, and I get it. No, people cap, it and these are definitely not the most organized people.
It is,
but
that goes without saying. So Omar, talk to us about your game, man. Yeah, I'm talking. You talking to a woman, right? You know what I'm saying?
Girl.
Omar, you talking to this woman. He's saying you send her some text, bro.
Women are afraid of us, so let's be clear on that. But if I'm funny. Am I not funny?
You're pretty funny.
So my game is usually...
I can't stand neither one of y'all right now.
You don't always have to be the funniest person.
My game... You funny? You're not funnier than me, but you funny?
I've never in my life, heard either one of y'all say I'm funny. Just to let y'all know that.
I said you was funny last time I was over here.
Not.
I said you was funny the last time I was over here, though.
Oh my god! You caught yourself laughing, and you're like,
"Oh no!" I said,
you make her laugh, you make her feel comfortable, and then immediately going for the touch. You know, you might get her behind the shoulder or the arm.
Trying to catch a charge.
Call her baby girl.
Okay.
Or just ask her what she liked to eat. Pose a question like, "Dog, I'm so sick of eating Jamaican food. Where you like to eat that?" And then she might say, "Oh, you know, around here I like to ha." And then that's where you go from there. Oh, word, you like to? Well, you know, when I get there, I'm not gonna know what to eat. So, I mean, you mind showing me or something like that?
Or what if she just thinks like, "Oh, this guy's very indecisive. He has no idea how to make decisions."
That's fine. But once you get her in the restaurant, it's all over from there. But 9 times out of 10, I'm not going to lie.
What do you do in restaurants usually?
Not that crazy. But I'm saying once I'm in the game at that point at the restaurant.
Okay, okay.
But what I'm going to do the first time is if I say something like, "Yeah, you know, well, you know, I won't know what to get. So why don't you accompany me to the restaurant?" Cap the first time. Make it seem like it's a misunderstanding. Make it seem like, "Oh, damn, he's very interesting. You know, he's got a lot going on." So I'm telling you what to say.
It's ridiculous.
So make it seem like you got a lot.
Okay, bro, stop.
I'm serious.
That's not helping. No, that's gonna help somebody.
That's gonna help you.
You walk up to a person. Wait, first of all, oh damn, you think I'm down bad right now?
No, I'm just saying that's gonna help you, my nigga. What the fuck?
Hey, no, bro. Why you think that's helpful information right there? That was not helpful at all.
Getting them to laugh is gonna get them comfortable.
That's okay, but first of all, that's hard to do.
No, it's not.
So a person you don't know, by the way, it's not like a person you've been friends with for a while. You can make random people laugh. You know how funny you got to be to walk up to a random person and make them laugh?
We literally been walking and somebody laughed just randomly.
This is coming from a perspective of somebody that's funny, though.
Like, I'm funny. I'm sick of this guy.
Yeah, back that, that's coming from people who are funny.
Yeah, you know. This coming from a perspective of somebody that's funny, though. So I think it's easy enough to make the girl laugh. And then the next step is finding a shared common interest, but don't push it like, you wear socks? I wear socks, too. Yeah, don't.
Is that Hanes?
Don't drag it. Yeah,
I ain't gonna hold you though. As somebody who relies on like making like females laugh, when it doesn't, when it doesn't work though, you be looking.
Okay, he's not lying.
Yeah, you be like, yo, that didn't hit. You can come with some heat.
And damn, they can't even fake laugh for you, Lil.
Nah, sometimes they don't.
Yo, sometimes they just be like, damn, that wasn't that.
And sometimes I've even had conversations with women that be like, yeah, I tried not to, I purposefully not laughed. It was just
sick ass niggas.
Yeah, they sick, but that's how they do. Imagine. I purposefully didn't laugh because I didn't, you know, I didn't want to let you know, like, give off that vibe to you. But me, in my head at the time, I gave you that heat, and you just sitting here with a straight face, like, if you don't stop talking to me.
Well, I done that a couple times in these moments videos. I know the joke I just dropped is a banger, but there's no response. And I'm like, man, fuck you guys. Yeah, I know this shit was heat. I already know it, bro. I don't need you guys' validation. I just got a comment. We could use a screen share for a moment. I don't exactly know what it's for, but it says, and I quote, "You fat bastard." I think he meant to say bastard.
Anyway. Yeah, that's crazy though. When you
hey, look, show that screen share, bro. Just randomly, just show that. Shut ass. It popped up right here.
Looks like I'm not going to use a screen share again. Just when you sitting there.
So you're not going to show people the comment?
No, I'm not.
That's tough.
Now what was I about to say? Oh yeah, but it's still just crazy. Yeah, when you try to make some, even in people general, but it's definitely when you're trying to, like, you know, break the ice.
You ever think like you go too far with the joke? Like, you're making her laugh, but then you just, why are you, like, you just keep joking, but like the joke is over.
After two giggles, I stop.
I catch myself having to like stop the next thought, which is going to be another attempt at a joke.
I try to downplay.
Just trying to spam jokes.
Surprisingly, I try to be humble in the very beginning because I'm not necessarily the most humble person. But yeah, being humble, it gets your pussy. So
does it?
Yeah,
yeah, sometimes it does. Yeah,
sometimes it does.
Okay, give me a situation in which that happened for you.
And I'm not gonna lie, if you got enough swag, see, I don't want to, no disrespect, I don't think you got enough swag to pull off.
Whoever that is banned from the house. Whoever is out there yelling right now while we're recording is banned. I don't care who it is.
That's Waleed bringing the East African teams.
And I'm telling you, whoever that lady is, she's banned.
Oh, shut up, bitch. No, but
Jesus,
that's a ban.
Cut that out.
That's a ban.
Sometimes they do like the arrogant though. I get off the arrogant.
I don't think humble works, bro.
So you like
humble it. only works when your confidence shows for itself. You know what I'm saying? Like, for example, if I pick up somebody in my Land Rover and then she doesn't see my other two cars until like the third date, then that humble kind of worked right there. But that's a lot, though.
But some women just like being modest. I'm going to be completely honest with you. I'm at a point now where if I try to be funny and you don't laugh at it, then I'm not like going to try to keep trying to make you laugh. Because
I know what type of woman you
because
are.
Because that means that you just don't find my same humor. Like, that's just what it is.
Oh, so that's a write-off. That's a write-off.
And I know it's a write-off. Yeah, I know, so I'm not going to try to hit you at a different angle with the humor. It's like, no, I mean, that's my type of humor. If you don't find that funny, then...
But then you can be bored, though, right? You can spend the rest of the time there bored.
But that's dating in general. That's just how dating works.
I don't date like that. Like, I'm not the, I find you attractive. Like, I'm walking up to just a woman. I want to take you out on a date. Because I don't want to run the risk of, damn, I got here... She's boring as hell. She was attractive in the store. She's boring.
And that happens a lot.
I know.
Keep going because I haven't said this part about the Bumble shit yet. I still haven't said that.
Oh, yet. Shit. We got an update.
No, it's not an update. Just the whole concept of like how Bumble works. And like Bumble is the
plus. Get this shit out the way first.
Oh, listen. I'm going to be quick now. But it was just. I've never.
Shut the fuck
up. I've never walked up. Yeah, let's go out. Because then I could only imagine if you sit there. And she's trying to tell me about her stuff. Yeah, I like Instagram and I like Love and Hip Hop and I like Real Housewives of Atlanta. What else do you like? Yeah, I like that. What type of music do you like? Drake and The Weeknd and Party Next Door. Nobody else? Nah, that's it.
And I'll be like, all right. So just waters, right?
Yeah.
Want some bread? We can get some bread.
And honestly, this is I'm gonna put you on a little bit of game.
Okay.
My mom told me this. She made a point when she was first dating, make sure y'all drive there separately. Make sure you get there separately.
Oh, without a doubt.
Never pick her up. Women don't go for that. Women don't go, now you got to pick me up if it's the first date. No, because I don't want to be stuck with you. If I don't like this date, I'm going to get up and leave.
I'm not going to lie to you.
I would want you to do
it. I'm not going to lie to you.
that's the fact that she did say that.
She said this.
Maybe it's just because I don't have to deal with issues, but I just order her Uber. I'm not going to. force myself to drop her off if I don't want to be there.
But see, I feel like there's an
element. You're not just send her Uber, or
that's the same concept though.
Same concept. There's an element in Atlanta.
Just get your own Uber.
There's an element in Atlanta, so I don't necessarily want to send her out.
Bro, if you have a bad date, is she catching her Uber back, or are you paying for that?
Like a really that has to be really bad.
Half of mine just like
you don't think I'm bad. I'm not dating no woman that's got to take an Uber.
But you pick her up though.
I'm not picking her up on the first date.
I'm saying, let's say you pick her up, right? Date goes horribly. Are you sending Uber back, or is she going to have to get home?
I would just drop her off though at that point. Unless I'm like really going, if I have to go like all the way out of my way, then no. If it's like right up the street, I don't mind just dropping you off.
And I don't want to put him on blast like that. Somebody that lives here drove. I remember we went out somewhere.
That's anonymous. We don't know who we're talking about.
We drove all the way to like Swanee. We drove like an hour.
And that nigga swears he doesn't simp. It's the craziest shit I've ever seen in my life.
An hour and some change away.
It's the craziest thing.
To pick up some folks.
The craziest thing that he thinks that he does not simp.
Was trying to come back to this side of town. And then have to drive all the way back to drop them off. I said, I'm not going to put him out. Dog, I'm not finna do that. So if you think no, you can leave me right here. I'll go home.
It's crazy that he don't think that he's.
He said, "Oh no, they decided they was gonna drive together." But he does. Apparently, he does that on very frequently. Drove an hour and some.
You don't know that.
That's mild.
It's very mild.
And then I think we got back at like 3. Omar, 3 or 4.
It's mild.
I'm telling you,
you haven't seen him cross state lines yet.
Oh no! I know about the cross state lines because that's another thing. It's been another time where I told him, yo, I'm finna be over there.
Oh my god!
And then he tells me, all right, I'll see you. You know when you get here. Me, all right, I'm about to leave my house now. I'm like halfway to Tennessee. Right?
Yes, that's one.
And like I said, I'm not. I don't want to say who it is. I'm halfway to Tennessee to go be. So at that point, I'm like, all right, fuck it. I stop doing what I'm doing. Go on Snapchat and look at the Snap stories.
Niggas hiking.
Same hand. I know the hands. I know the little hand attack. Like I know what's going on. Man, niggas is tripping.
Hiking. Going back to the boring part though, because like women are like. On Bumble, right? For people who don't know how the app works, like if y'all match up, the woman has to initiate.
I thought I just saw some. Maybe I'm bugging.
What happened?
I'm bugging.
Bumble.
Trust me.
Go ahead, nigga.
I may have saw him just trying to lick the mic, but I might be bugging.
What?
I don't know what I did. I saw. That's because
you saw that D-Wade video. You going nuts?
Yo, chill out.
And I fuck with Wade. It's Wade County, but I don't. Yeah, you tripping.
On Bumble, you have to once you match up, like when you and the person match up, the woman has to initiate the conversation, right?
What?
So is that so?
That's a trap, man.
The craziest part is like, as a man, you're like conditioned to always initiate, and you know how to like entertain to begin a conversation XYZ. The amount of women that I've matched with on Bumble who have like the most boring. It's the driest shit I've ever seen in my life.
They don't have a single interesting thing about them.
But it's not even just about them. Like, you know, like you be doing it sometimes too, but like all do, like when you first try to text somebody, you be trying to craft like the perfect text that's engaging enough, but not too much. And it's also entertaining, but it's like a little bit of like who you are. Like it's something that's interesting that can start a legit conversation. I swear it's either, hey, how you doing? Or it's, what are you doing on this app? Like some like corny.
Same shit you doing on this app.
Or it may be even, I didn't even know Bumble had like prompted.
That prompt things. Shit is fucking dope, by the way. Just for certain conversations. But it makes it so much easier.
But the fact that they use the prompt is like, nigga, like what's going on? And it's the same prompts.
I want to show you an example.
Yeah, bro, it's so dry conversation. It's like y'all just think, and so then what's crazy is if I stay dry with you, then you're gonna be upset. But you're still relying on me to like open up the conversation up, even though you're on Bumble and that's the purpose of the app.
Look at this. These prompts are blessed. So this prompt says you should not go out with me if you're only looking for hookups, right? That's a pretty common thing women say. Mm. And so I started the convo with, I'm only looking for hookups. Am I in the wrong place? That's fucking, I bet she fucking giggled when she read that shit. And then we had a conversation. Dry as shit. God damn it. Cause let's say I ask you just a generic question.
Dry.
Let's say I'm like, hey, so like, what do you do? Right? If you ask me that question, I'll be like, I just create content. But I can't stop there because then I just killed the convo. I have to say something interesting that she can have a response about.
Yeah,
but they don't do that a lot of the time. This shit is so frustrating, man. So it's like, I just end up in like an interrogation. I'm just asking questions because you're not saying anything interesting for me to bounce back off. You know how boring you're being right now? And that's the same. There's the same type of woman is going to end up like in their bio is going to be like, only if you know how to hold a conversation. Oh, my God. Look inwards. Sometimes it's you.
They don't understand the difference between being like protective with their information versus being like you're just a dry person. Because I don't want to have to fish for, oh, you work at Delta? Okay, well, what do you do at Delta? Oh, you like, please elaborate what you do at Delta.
Word. Why did you stop at I work at, like, tell me.
I'm not coming up there to do anything crazy like with you at Delta. Like, come on now. Mm.
But again, it's the whole concept of Bumble is for her to initiate the conversation. So it's not just you initiate it just so I can pick it up where you decided to just drop it off randomly. No, like, initiate a conversation. Have something interesting to say. Not just, oh, hey, how you doing?
But that's a setup, though. I told you this before, off the pod. It's easier if I start the conversation because I'm going to have something more interesting to say. If you start the conversation, it's going to be way less fun. It's going to be more boring. So when the women have to start the conversations, you're already starting off on the wrong foot. Because lots of the time, they're probably getting so many fucking swipes, they're not going to try with every guy.
Yeah.
So they can just write some bullshit so that you can figure it out. Figure out how to make this interesting for me.
I know they have their generic posts too
for the thousands of swipes they get.
Irritating. But that's a part of the dating app. So if you're on the dating app, that's what you kind of gotta.
But that's the difference on Bumble. All of them have their own thing, and that's the difference. That's the thing on Bumble is that you as the, and part of it is I'm pretty sure women just don't want to get random dick pics to try to like start conversations. So I get that part of it. But also a part of it is, since you are the one starting the conversation, just for once in the relationship that you're trying to engage in right now, just do what men have to do almost every single time when they want to start a conversation with new people, and that is be more engaging. Just don't leave it on the, oh, hey, how are you doing?
Plus they've never, it's not been the norm though, so they don't know how to approach it that way.
Then get off Bumble then.
Yeah.
Then get off Bumble.
So women aren't clowns? You want to double down on that one?
I can't. I haven't spoken to all women. See what I'm saying? I'm trying to get my words underneath me. The reality is most people is clowns, Omar. And you kind of just have to navigate in life knowing that.
I do fuck with women. I want them to be.
You fuck with
second time you said that.
That's what you say before.
I fuck with y'all.
Some hater shit is following up.
No. I see what you're saying. And if they want those norms to like be taken out, take charge.
They don't really want the norms. They don't want the norms to be taken out.
In fact, I actually am more engaged in the conversation when she starts it. Because then at least I know she's interested. So then.
She's giving effort. I enjoy that.
When I start the conversations, it's a way higher likelihood that she's going to be dry as fuck.
Yes.
But if she's starting it, then I'm like, all right.
But remember, she's been taught her whole life. You know, you're not supposed to start it. You're not supposed to. Da-da-da-da.
Then get the fuck off of Bumble. Then that's literally the premise of Bumble. If you don't want to start the conversation, then get the fuck off of the app. Then that's literally all you have to do. That's it.
Oh, you should be an ambassador.
But as a side note, since you wanted to update, that's the reason why I fucks with her. You know, I fucks with women, right? You know that, right?
Wait, be specific. Who are you fucking with?
They fuck with women, just in general.
In general? Just all women?
Just in general, yeah. Oh, but that's the reason why I enjoy having a conversation with the I guess you, what you call it, a teacher bay? Is that what you call it?
I've never in my life used those words. It might be Waleed. I don't know.
Oh, okay, Waleed. Yeah, the one I met on Bumble.
I just gave her name. I just called her Jeanette. I don't even know if that's.
Oh, yeah, okay, Jeanette. I just made it. The woman I met on Bumble, who was a teacher, because she initiated a conversation way more interesting than anybody else did and knew how to hold a conversation. So
Word. Yeah. Hey, man, those apps are fucking cancer. Swear to God, that shit is cancer. The likelihood you're going to meet someone of value on that app, almost non-existent. But then if you do, there's like so many ways for that to fucking go horribly wrong. See what I'm saying?
Which, so crazy. I have to keep catching myself because I'm like, because I sat there and I said, yeah, come over to the house. Because, you know, y'all were giving me bad advice for a first date during the lockdown.
What would you do for a first date?
During, out of curiosity.
You don't have an iPhone, so
talking to the.
Yeah, I'm saying you don't have an iPhone, so you don't have an iPhone, so it'll probably be definitely like a virtual. I would like a FaceTime day. I would do like a FaceTime. You have dinner in front of you. I have dinner in front of me, and we're gonna do like
that. That is a corner.
I don't know why I ever asked.
Wait, let me get it up. We're gonna be eating like
So you wrap this,
electronic.
You wrap this
these things are stuff is lifting. So if you're talking about like deep in the quarantine, it would definitely have to be like a FaceTime.
Oh well, phone. Yeah. If it's that deep, then yeah, we
like right now, bro.
You know, right now, yeah. You can still go out now.
But where? You're asking me where?
Definitely, you have to get to a park or something like that.
Okay, that's
what. Yeah, you definitely have to get to a park.
That's what I'm.
You can sit down in some restaurants. I just don't.
I don't even like going to restaurants for first dates though, because it's too many awkward silences and y'all eating in the middle of shit. And y'all
I disagree with that.
Bro. If there's too many awkward silences, that's not the one for you.
No. Why can't there be silence? Why does it always have to be awkward?
It doesn't have to be. It doesn't have to be like a constantly ongoing conversation. But
I said awkward silences.
Yeah,
very awkward is just in your head though. If both of you guys didn't believe it was awkward, then it would just be silence.
Nah,
I'm not saying you have to consistently like have an ongoing conversation for however long y'all are there, but it just needs. I feel like it's way more natural when there's something else going on around you outside of food being served.
Yeah, because it just feels weird when I talk about food for the 12th time that day.
That's what I'm saying. Yeah, I don't want. I want to see them.
Wow,
like,
this man, steak.
What are you getting?
Good. Spaghetti was good.
Yeah,
man.
Oh, so, what you sounded like you were getting. It sounds like it's gonna be good. Mm. So.
Can't wait till I get mine. Are you going to wait for me?
Yeah. Dessert? Yeah. You going to get dessert too? Yeah. No?
Boy, I'm already thinking of dessert after that. Like, yeah. No.
You want a diet? Oh, man. What type of diet? Like I don't want to. No, that's
kind
of.
And again, fellas. This
I didn't tell you to do that, though. I did say just go to the movies. Well, you can't do that now, but I'm telling you the movies is lit.
The movies is a terrible date because you can't get to know the person.
No, exactly. But you get to know them after the movie, this man bro. Said, the movie's not the only part.
This man said, once we get done with the movies, we're going to have a pop quiz on the movie.
Why are you lying to people? All right, let's say you go watch Interstellar, right? And after that, just walk in the park. Boom. Now you have content to talk about. You already kind of familiar being around one another.
It's like a 4-hour date.
So let me tell you a couple things wrong with that. First of all,
in the walk, bro.
It's your opinion. You're wrong. So, first of all, movies are like 3 hours now, right?
That's true. Some movies are 3 hours.
And then the genre of movie you like probably doesn't align with the woman that you're seeking to.
Nope, then we can't go out.
I'm being dead serious. For me. I'm being dead serious about both men and women. Like, if let's say hypothetically speaking, like again, going back to like the laughs and jokes and shit like that, like if you have a certain type of humor, don't try to like conform the way that you laugh to somebody else just because you're trying to entertain them on a first date or trying to be more acceptance or you trying to go to a certain type of, because the chick I was going with right now, she's saying like, let's go bike riding.
Oh yeah, yeah. No,
she said let's go ride some bikes. Yeah. I was like dead ass. I was like, yeah, no, I'm not riding
if
bikes.
I ever catch you on a motherfucking bike, Lo, if I ever catch you riding a bike, I know you have a car.
I'm not riding a bike.
I agree with you because I've been invited to like lounges to be like, that's like that's not me. I'm not finna compromise.
Who you are.
That's lame as hell.
Why would you start? You gonna start the relationship already compromising? That's crazy.
I can't say.
And I go that definitely. That's a part of your simp story. But if you, especially both, that goes both ways too. Don't compromise if you don't fuck with and drive on the first date. I promise you can leave.
Yeah, don't ride bikes.
you can leave.
I hope you don't do that, bro. No cap.
I straight up said, yeah, I'm not riding a bike.
So. But tell her, like, yo, there's scooters though. It's way more fun.
I'm definitely not riding a bike.
What do you mean scooters? Like the little, yeah. You got to pay for the scooter?
Yeah.
What the fuck are you gonna do with that?
Well, Lowe's gonna have to pay for a bike because I know he don't own one right now. So it's the same shit.
Biking stupid too. I'm gonna be focused on biking.
Word. Yeah, that's all bad ideas. Honestly, I don't even know what a good idea is except for just chilling and walking in the park or some shit.
Yeah, right now. But normally what I would do is kind of like go to like a light arcade-ish type of place. Like the place
that's mad generic, my guy. Very generic.
I don't know if it's that.
You mean like Dave and Buster's?
No, not like, because Dave and Buster's, like, I think that's too arcade.
What's that? I know what you're talking about.
It's a place downtown.
Like where they have like arcade games. No, like those games, like that.
Oh, like an arcade.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm not talking about.
Bro, that won't even be fun. I'd just be, come on. I'd be hitting the combos and I have to like stop winning because.
I mean, come out of it for a second and play it and talk to her, my nigga.
The girl you're talking to would be like, Tekken 7 was there, she'd be gassed. No, bro. She could go on to play Pac-Man or something.
And that's fine.
I mean, that's fine. You don't have to be a competitive one.
Do you hate Pac-Man?
You gotta go hard.
Like in the first day. Something like that.
But one is obviously more entertaining than the other.
But it doesn't. All I'm saying is, but I do believe she would be gas in general for arcade though.
Where?
Yeah, I think y'all wouldn't mind her. But the thing is, I'm not bringing her around you.
Hey,
definitely not doing that. So is that?
Because why? Why? What are you nervous about? Low, talk to us.
Not doing that.
What are you feeling right now? Why are you feeling nervous?
Tell me when she come over, because I'm gonna push up. I'm gonna go crazy.
Not doing either one of those things.
Hey, just let you know that you're gonna have to sacrifice your quality time with her. Because you can't bring her over when I'm around. I'm not even going to tell you when I plan on leaving the house no more. Because you might just sneak her in. I'm going to make sure I'm at the crib. Hey, Marcel, where you at down there, bro? You can
bring her downstairs. Don't.
Yeah, I've done it multiple times.
Don't pitch a home first date. Don't be like, yeah, you can come back to my house. That's creepy.
Is it?
Yes.
I know.
I've been trying to tell him this, but we'll talk.
I can't even say that.
Exactly. You can't.
No, you don't even know.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
But the crazy thing is, like, they were sitting there trying to tell me, yeah, just told her to come over to the house. And I'm like,
hell no, that's crazy.
That's not how that goes. That's not how that goes. I don't know.
It's your first time meeting. It's like, yeah, just come to my house.
But in quarantine, it'd be more understandable, though.
No, I'm not coming to nobody's house. Then I just don't need to date. If you're talking about some, oh, yeah, come to my house. I don't even know you.
Like, yeah, I'm not. Yeah, there's no need for that.
You better FaceTime me. Mm. We better e-date. Eating.
So you ready?
Yeah, real ready.
He just brought the eating joke.
Yeah, so that's for the second time. Even though it didn't hit the first time, you tried it again.
Done. That's tough.
Hey, man.
That's crazy when you think you're funny, you try to do the joke, double back on the same joke.
Yeah, just in case we didn't hear it.
Like, but y'all got that, right? Eating, get it? Y'all got that?
We heard you, Omar. It was bad.
You good?
Hey, if you guys enjoyed the pod, make sure to drop a like, subscribe to the channel. If you're on YouTube, make sure to go.
Are these the things? Damn, they caught me. I don't stay around that long.
I'm not uploading this if you don't say it.
You had to say it, bro. What? If you're on YouTube, make sure to go.
Oh, hit the bell, man. Hit the bell. Become part of Noti. No?
All you got to do is say it. You don't have to say hit the bell.
Oh, become Noti gang gang.
Gang 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 gang
gang gang gang gang gang.
That's
what
you had to say, bro.
I thought you was gonna do the flex.
Omar, come on. How'd you fail it twice in the same podcast?
That's crazy.
I thought it was some different shit.
Crazy.
Hey, Spotify, Stitcher, Google Play people, thank you guys. Apple Podcasts, drop a 5-star. Remember, podcasts drop every Monday and Thursday. We try to do a better job of reminding people that since people think it just drops sporadically, it doesn't. It's Monday and Thursday, usually in the evening.
Yeah, why don't Eastern people just keep saying that? Y'all just, when are y'all dropping? It's like, man,
I feel like y'all,
we in like episode like 35 right now. Like, how do y'all not know?
I think days have been jumbled though, so maybe that's why.
Oh, true.
Word. Omar, any last words?
I actually am gonna break into the content creation game, so Omizi on all these platforms.
That's not about to be your name though.
No, it really is Omizi. That's my name though, so don't and off camera I'm gonna tell you about yourself, but don't ever do that again. I'll see if my brother is so willing to put my links in the description.
Yeah, I'm gonna put your.
Wait, you already have a channel?
Yeah, I created a
channel. Imagine you beat this guy. Because he's been procrastinating forever.
Second channel?
Yeah.
I created a channel. Me and my friends are gonna do a triathlon. I think that'll be my first video. You know, we'll get
that
some.
That sounds like terrible. Torture.
We'll get some good things out there.
Y'all put your Twitter in a
you know my YouTube video. Take this.
It's cold out, fellas. It's cold out.
Take that.
Bundle up. Put your Scullies on.
They didn't hear nothing you said because his coat was just rumbling in the goddamn mic.
Hey, hold on. I can hear your waves.
Anyway. Yeah, I'm about to
double entendre.
And I'm going to try to bring us all together. We'll do a million man Jesus. YouTube march.
I'll do the triathlon with you.
Okay.
Yeah.
Say less.
For like a kilometer.
So we're done?
Low, any final words?
Not like a real triathlon.
I'm done. I'm ready to go.
All right. I'm ready to go too since it's 1 a.m.
Yeah, it's 1 a.m.
Oh, hold on. Finish off with a quick four.
Hell no.
Oh, man. Wow.
I'm ready to go. It's 1 o'clock in the morning. So.
Yeah, me
I need
too.
That soda massage.
I'm exhausted. I'm going to go to sleep. I'm running on energy drinks today. So I'll catch you guys in the next podcast. Deuces.